The heartbeat of vision. The drama of the moment. This is TNT Sports.
TNT Sports presents the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Ceremony. A salute to the sport and a celebration with its champion. New York City at Christmas time, always bright with lights and glowing with the spirit of her people. And while each night the streets are lit with the multicolored bulbs of the holiday season, this city, like all others in our country, proudly displays its brightest colors every day. Red, white, and blue. The Waldorf Astoria Hotel is a New York City landmark, and for the 21st consecutive year, it plays host to NASCAR's best on NASCAR's biggest night. It has been a week of sightseeing, celebrating, and of course, shopping. But for many of this sport's most famous and friendly faces, it has also been a week full of emotional visits and many thanks to New York's finest and New York's bravest. The NYPD, the Fire Department of New York, and the Port Authority Police Department. So tonight, after thanking our heroes with their hands and their hearts, this sport is ready to salute its stars. Good evening and welcome to New York City. I'm Bill Weber, and it is an honor to serve as your host for the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards Ceremony. Throughout the season, Winston Cup teams compete on Sunday afternoons, occasional Saturday nights, and this year, for the first time in 30 years, on a Friday afternoon. The goal each week is to win the race, but the ultimate goal is to make it here to the Waldorf in a table reserved only for the best. A table marked Winston Cup champion. It's always a pleasure to be working alongside 1973 Winston Cup champion Benny Parsons. And Benny, your ceremony was in a more intimate setting in Daytona Beach. This is a big night in the Big Apple.
Well, it's a huge night, and it all starts in February. This past February, about 45 teams went to Daytona, thinking about winning the Daytona 500, but also in the back of the mind, wanting to be here at the Waldorf as champions of 2001. By the time we got back to Daytona in July, it was obvious that about half the teams were eliminated. And then with three or four races to go, it looked like Jeff Gordon and his team were the team of destiny for 2001. So let the party begin.
And it's going to be a wild night, isn't it?
It is that.
It has been an amazing year. And while one man won six times, this 36-race season of success was shared by so many. A record 19 different drivers roared into victory lane, some after a spectacular burnout, and some after a not-so-spectacular burnout. Five drivers won for the first time. So now let's take a look back at the men and the moments before it's time to move on.
Hamilton will lead them off of turn two. Final time down the back stretch. Rusty Wallace has the lead.
And he's got one eye on the fuel gate, one eye toward the checkered flag. Ricky Rudd, this will be a popular win.
Tony Stewart pulling away from Robbie Gordon, and Tony Stewart will win.
Final lap of the Pepsi 400. Michael Waltrip in second, but it's going to be Dale Earnhardt Jr.
His first win as Winston Cup champion. Tony Stewart gets his third win of 2001. Comes to the caution and white flags and wins the Southern 500. And it's going to be a big night in the championship for Ricky Rudd. Checkered flag is up. Rudd wins the Chevy Monte Carlo 400 at Richmond. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is going to lead 193 of 400 laps. The American and checkered flags out at Dover. Here he comes to the checkered flag. Rudd wins in Kansas City. Now he's going to get
get the win in the UAW GM Quality 500. Marlin wins at Charlotte. Ricky Craven is a NASCAR Winston Cup winner.
Drivers and teams that are truly driven. The race season may be over, but for some guys, this is the toughest track of all. Walking onto the stage at the Waldorf. Get ready, NASCAR in New York is about to take the green flag on TNT.
This holiday season, Garth Brooks is giving Christmas a whole new swing.
I have to find somebody to take my place before midnight on Christmas Eve.
I don't suppose you'd take no for an answer, would you?
Call me Santa, call me Kringle, call me El Saint Nick.
Whoopi Goldberg and Nigel Hawthorne in a movie that finds the true spirit of Christmas with new music from Garth Brooks. Call Me Claus. See the world premiere Sunday at 8, only on TNT.
Just getting started when the long day ends. This bud's for you. And you and you and you. This bud's for you.
She's not your daughter. But if you give her a ride home after school, she might as well be. Carpooling. On the wings of Goodyear.
At the Home Depot, we're driving down the cost of home improvement. Now through December 2nd, you can put zero money down and get zero payments with 0% interest till January of 2003 on any Home Depot consumer credit card purchases totaling $299 or more. Imagine, no money down, no payments, and no interest for over a year. In-store or online, the best gifts come in a bright orange box at the Home Depot.
The 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Awards Ceremony is brought to you by Budweiser. With the crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer. This Bud's for you. By Goodyear, reminding you to take all of life's journeys on the wings of Goodyear. By the Home Depot, the official home improvement warehouse of NASCAR. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of NASCAR. And welcome back to New York City. Bill Weber and Benny Parsons high up in the balcony here at the Waldorf. And we are joined by the man of the hour, four-time NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon. Did you get a good seat?
I think we got a pretty good seat, yeah. We're the only one left at a table.
You've had quite a week. Let's see, it was the Today Show, Regis, Drew Carey, Letterman. Glad you could work us in.
It's been an incredible week, and the sport has grown so much over the years. Just from 98 to this year, so many things have changed. This city has really become a big fan of NASCAR, and NASCAR has really made its place even in a big city like New York.
Jeff, four championships.
Where did they come from, Benny?
I don't know.
I don't know it either.
How does this one stack up? Was number one better, or is this one better? Did it get better as they go?
They get better as they go, definitely. It really has just been an amazing year for our entire team to rebuild and do all the things that we did from last year to this year. New guy like Robbie Loomis, have Rick Hendrick back. It's been absolutely awesome. Best one ever.
Jeff, it's been an amazing year on and off the racetrack, not only for people in this sport, but for Americans around this country and around the world. You are now obviously a leader on the track, but do you feel that this championship puts you in a role to lead off the track as well?
Well, I think that we've got so much talent, so many different great personalities within our sport that we've got a lot of leaders. And I think all of us have to play that role and to step up and do what it takes to take this sport to the next level, along with NASCAR, along with our sponsors, our track owners, everybody that plays a role, the team owners, and I'm proud to be one of those, and proud to play my part for sure.
Okay. Well, thanks for giving back the fire truck too. Okay?
Safely.
Congratulations. Thank Enjoy
you.
Your evening.
Appreciate it.
Jeff.
Thank you, Benny.
Congratulations, man.
So, what do you think, Benny? You ready for a big night? You comfortable?
Well, as comfortable as I can get with all this. Pretty comfortable.
Well, you have to stay in that because it's the dress code for the evening. Now, we certainly should expect two themes throughout the night: the professional pride and respect the people in this sport hold for what the late Dale Earnhardt did accomplish, and the sense of how proud people are for what New York City and Americans around the country and around the world are accomplishing. So make yourself comfortable as we welcome you to one flashy night in the fast lane.
No movie has captured our imagination like The Wizard of Oz. Now TNT brings you behind-the-scenes footage and celebrity interviews in a special presentation. See The Wizard of Oz. Tomorrow night at 8 on TNT.
This Tuesday...
She's becoming a fury. There's no reasoning with her now.
The Charmed Ones face losing their own sister as Piper falls victim to the Furies.
I know where evil dwells.
Get Charmed. Tuesday night at 10 on TNT. We know drama.
Alan Bestwick with Benny Parsons here to tell you about this year's must-have gift from UMI, the NASCAR Winston Cup Yearbook.
Alan, this year's edition is the biggest ever. It includes a special section celebrating 30 years of NASCAR Winston Cup champions. Names like Earnhardt, Petty, Gordon, and even me.
The NASCAR Winston Cup Yearbook is the perfect Christmas gift. It's a true racing collectible. This is the book that's presented at the banquet each year. It's never reprinted, not available in any bookstore, and filled with 300 pages of the best images of the NASCAR Winston Cup season, bound with a rich bonded leather cover.
This book is a great gift, but only limited numbers are available to the public. And at $39.95, they sell out fast. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
When you purchase your NASCAR Winston Cup Yearbook and the official NASCAR Preview Magazine, you get this free commemorative 30 years of Winston Cup champion CD. Ask your operator for details. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
Limited numbers available. Call now.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why.
The holiday balls are coming to town. We see you when you're sleeping. We know when you're awake. We know if you've been bad or good. So be good, for goodness sake.
Stop by and get a free holiday ball when you buy a sourdough jack combo.
The holiday balls are coming to town.
There you go.
The Dodge Dakota offers best-in-class cargo and payload.
Woo! What is that? You can put your arms down, you know. That'll be good.
Now get 7-year or 100,000-mile powertrain protection and 0% APR on 2002 Dodge Dakota.
Give it up!
Unity!
Woo!
Stop!
going to be a big night in the championship for Ricky Rudd. Contact! Bobby Labonte's over! It's the big wreck on the final lap! They're racing back for the win! Dale Earnhardt Jr. has won here in Talladega! Jeff Gordon has locked up the championship.
TNT Sports welcomes you live to New York City for the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards ceremony. Each year, the stars of the sport make the trip to the city to share in the excitement and the coronation of a new champion. Each year, it's a special trip, but this year, it is certainly extra special to be in New York. Inside the famous Waldorf Astoria Hotel, the guests have been seated and the big night is about to begin. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your master of ceremonies for this evening, the voice of NASCAR racing from TNT and NBC Sports, Mr. Alan Bestwick.
Thank you. Thank you, Bill. Good evening and welcome. Tonight we honor the youngest four-time champion in the history of the NASCAR Winston Cup Series, and we know you're anxious to get started. So let's welcome the members of the championship team that'll be seated at the head table. Representing DuPont, accompanied by his wife Karen, the president of DuPont Performance Coatings, Ed Donnelly. From the Hendrick Motorsports Engine Department, accompanied by his wife, Diane, the director of the engine program, Randy Dorton. The NASCAR Winston Cup champion crew chief, accompanied by his sister, Colleen, Robbie Loomis. Champion car owner, accompanied by his wife Linda, Mr. Rick Hendrick. And accompanied by his wife Brooke, our 2001 four-time NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, Jeff Gordon. Also joining us tonight as guests of honor, please join me in recognizing the entire Hendrick Motorsports number 24 DuPont Chevrolet team. Rick, did somebody steal your seat? Can we grab a chair for Mr. Hendrick, please? We just can't have this. Very good, Jeff. Very good. All right. Mr. Hendrick, if you'd like, you can come up here and take my place, and I'll go down there in the audience. All right. Well, while we wait for that chair to be delivered, let's move on with our first presentation. Jeff, you're saved. Now we've got two. I think somebody called a two-tire stop and we got four. All right, let's move on. Our first guest tonight and our first presentation comes from a well-known fan of the sport and a pretty familiar face on television and along pit road at many NASCAR Winston Cup events. Please join me in welcoming NBC News anchorman Brian Williams.
Thank you, Alan. Good evening, everyone. I'm proud to be here tonight on a stage that has hosted so much greatness over the years. many of us who are fans of this sport associate NASCAR Winston Cup drivers with great courage. But lately we have seen a whole different kind of courage, the kind of courage exemplified by Terry Hatton. He is captain of Manhattan's prestigious Rescue One, just a few blocks from here. For some perspective, if you're captain of Rescue One in New York, it makes you one of the best firefighters in the country. The morning of September 11th, when Captain Terry Hatton pulled up to the World Trade Center, he said to the fire truck driver in the cab next to him, "I love you, brother. This may be the last time I see you." Moments after saying those words, Terry Hatton was killed when the Trade Center collapsed around him. He was not yet 42 years old. At least now, the whole world knows what firefighters and emergency service workers do. They are the ones always running in when others are running out. Tonight, we would like to honor the heroes of that morning in this city. With us this evening are Spencer Barber, Port Authority, EMS. Firefighter Bill Butler, FDNY. Police officer Denise Cross, NYPD. Police officer Benjamin Cruz, NYPD. Don Firehawk, Port Authority, EMS. Keith Johnson, FDNY. Ralph Macchia, FDNY. And finally, Officer Danny Ramirez, NYPD. Earlier this week, Jeff Gordon, Rick Hendrick, and Robbie Loomis had the honor of visiting with Engine Company 24, Ladder 5, as well as the 9th Precinct.
Here we go.
Yes, sir.
Here now, a NASCAR tribute to this city and the people who make their living protecting it, the heroes who are on the job 24 hours a day, those who help to make New York the great city that it is.
Somebody could come in here and do this to us and disrupt us like this. I just couldn't imagine that happening.
I can't believe that people are raised to do that. You think about running, it's like, no, I don't want to practice today, and we just loaded up and left.
This sport is fun to watch. It's entertainment. For us, it's our world, but it's a really small thing when it comes to when you compare it to everything else in the world.
A lot of people make a big deal out of what we do. Are y'all going to race? Are football players going to play? And it is big to us because that's our world. But could you imagine having to march back into New York City and go up in your office and be a banker or be a lawyer or be a broadcaster and look out your window and those buildings aren't there anymore?
Then the New York won't be the same. I mean, not without those, without the buildings like they are. I mean, it's just not going to be the same.
As Americans, we go on. That's what we do.
Smiling lately, dreaming about the world as one, and I believe it could be someday it's gonna come. 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country, come on, take me home again. Oh, home again.
It is truly an honor to be here in New York City with our ceremony tonight. Our awards presentations begin with the 10th place driver coming up in just a moment.
This is Santa's Workshop 2001. Billions of wish lists come in from around the world, and UPS helps us navigate supply chain management issues.
Oh, coal comes in from the Balkans for the naughty.
Boy band figurines come in from Japan for the nice.
Think about the logistics on that one.
We have been a successful brand for centuries now, and for a number of years, UPS has been an invaluable partner. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus, and he's working with UPS.
Celebrating by Team Monte Carlo.
Now the first thing you've got to do is jump up here and scream and yell, woo! Make sure your hat guy forms them first so you don't end up looking like a dork. Now when somebody hands you one of these babies, make sure you say thanks. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, man, don't eat the check.
Want to be like Jeff Gordon? Drive the Chevy Monte Carlo. The cars more champions depend on. Chevy, we'll be there.
We ought to be flying for a rock star.
We could save the music.
They fired us! Eject! Eject!
Now, get ready.
Our man is down behind enemy lines.
To cross the line.
The American people want their pilot back.
Behind enemy lines.
You're so funky, Dixie.
Rated PG-13. Now playing only in theaters.
Buying a car is
that easy, so easy.
Hayes Mitsubishi does make it easy during the annual No Excuses Clearance Event. For a limited time, you can purchase a new Hayes Mitsubishi with zero down, zero interest, and make zero payments for 15 months. Take one home today and drive it free till 2003. Or choose 0% financing in all new full-size Monteros, Montero Sports, and Diamantes. Hayes Mitsubishi, where it really is that easy.
Time, get $200 in free accessories or clothing with select models.
See the complete line of Yamaha motorcycles at America's Motorsports in Nashville and Madison.
The drivers who finished from 2nd through 10th places in the final NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship. To present those awards, join me in welcoming the president of Sports Marketing Enterprises for the R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Mr. Rick Sanders.
Thank you, Alan, and good evening. On behalf of everyone at NASCAR, R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, and our Winston brand, we want to also extend our welcome to the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Award Ceremony. You know, this year marked Winston's 31st year of involvement in what has become unquestionably the premier motorsports series in the world. The 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup season proved to be a year filled with as much drama and as much emotion as any other year in the storied history of this series. Tonight, we are going to officially put 2001 into the record books, crowning Jeff Gordon and this year's remarkable championship team, and recognizing on stage here tonight the nine other drivers and teams who finished at the top of the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup point standings. I think everyone in this room knows how hard it is in this series to win a race. And harder still is achieving a top 10 finish in the point standings after a 36 race season. Finishing in the Winston Cup Series top 10 means that a team has not only done well on the track, but they've also demonstrated an ability to perform consistently throughout the season, whether it be on short tracks, road courses, speedways, or super speedways. The drivers and teams we recognize on stage tonight have proven themselves as being the best of the best in the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series. So, Alan, what do you say? Let's get on with tonight's celebration and let's meet this year's top 10 drivers.
I think that's a great idea. Let's start with our 10th place driver, the number of the 99 Citgo Ford, Jeff Burton.
Embarking upon his sixth full season teamed with car owner Jack Roush, the 1994 Raybestos Rookie of the Year earned his fifth consecutive top 10 finish in the season-ending NASCAR Winston Cup Series standings. In April, the Citgo SuperGuard Ford driver scored his first top five of 2001 by racing to a third-place finish at Martinsville. In May, Burton ended a season-long drought by racing to victory at Charlotte. Back-to-back eighth-place showings at Sears Point and Daytona marked the resurgence of the Frank Stoddard-led team, which yielded a runner-up finish at Watkins Glen in August. The younger of the racing Burton brothers, Jeff scorched through the season's final months with four successive top five finishes, highlighted by a dominating repeat victory at Phoenix. In fact, over the season's final six events, no driver scored more NASCAR Winston Cup points than Jeff Burton. Achieving two wins, eight top fives, and 16 top tens, please welcome driver of the Jack Roush-owned Citgo SuperGuard Ford from South Boston, Virginia, Jeff Burton.
Jeff, I have to tell you, we were all surprised, as a matter of fact, early in the season, you guys just seemed to be struggling. Matter of fact, I think it was all the way through the seventh race of the year with Texas, You were 35th in the point standings. And we said, boy, he's probably not going to make it up here this year. What was truly remarkable, though, is you just kept pushing. The team kept fighting through that struggle in probably one of the most remarkable demonstrations of consistency since then. You made it back up on this stage tonight. It's my pleasure on behalf of NASCAR and Winston to provide you with your trophy for your 10th place finish this year and a check in the amount of $363,404. Congratulations,
Thank
Jeff.
You. Thank you. Well, we drivers have quite a scam, don't we? We make this kind of money doing what we do for fun. Not sure how we pull that off, but we do it somehow. I want to thank Winston for all their ongoing support. Their commitment is really unmatched by anyone in the sport. This really hadn't been the year we had hoped it would be, obviously. But then again, I don't think it was a year that any of us had hoped for, and for many reasons. No, we didn't lead as many laps, and we didn't win as many races, and we surely were not as consistent as we were a year ago. But in the grand scheme of things, I think we, and I mean we as a country, not just we in the racing world, learning that perhaps there's some things much more important than just leading races and winning races. I think that perhaps the most important thing for everyone this past year was to learn a little bit about ourselves. There are many things this year that I've learned, both personally and professionally. I learned that Winston Cup racing is much harder than I thought it would be. And that's saying a lot, because I think it's really hard. This sport feels the most competitive racing in the world. If you can win here, you can win anywhere. Another thing I learned is how compassionate this sport is. Through the tragedies, everyone stepped up to lend a hand, from drivers to crew members, owners and sponsors. What I've seen in this sport is unbelievable. I've seen so many selfless acts and so much gratitude from the entire community that it makes me proud to be involved with such a great group of people. And it makes me even more proud to be an American. Conviction as a team is something I learned. This team never gave up. And when I say team, I mean everybody within Roush Racing. Even though results didn't show it, Frank Stoddard had his best year ever as a crew chief. Through adversity, I believe you learn what people are made of. And this team is made of a lot. We never gave up. We stayed strong and we kept fighting. And because of that, I'm up here tonight representing each and every one of the team. I also learned not to take things for granted this year. I received some great advice from the Petty family. One advice which I hold really close to my heart. They told me you should never let a chance go by where you don't grab your kids, pick them up and hug them, and tell them how much you love them. My wife Kim, who's my biggest supporter, has made that her highest priority. Each of our sponsors was in our fight with us, and we appreciate their support through the good times and the bad times. I want to thank Ford, Goodyear, SKF, Chicago Rawhide, Coca-Cola, Parts Plus, Mack Tools, Bosch, OnSite, Petridge Farm, AT&T, Mayflower, and Sherwin-Williams. That's a lot of them, and we appreciate every one of them. Most importantly, I want to thank CITGO for such a wonderful partnership. They've been involved with NASCAR for a long time, and we appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Jeff, thank you. Finishing in ninth place, our NASCAR Winston Cup Series Rookie of the Year, driver of the number 29 GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet, Kevin Harvick.
Thrust into the national spotlight in February, the 2001 Raybestos Rookie of the Year quickly found success. In just his third NASCAR Winston Cup start, the 26-year-old edged his way to his first Winston Cup Series win at Atlanta in March. While competing full-time for car owner Richard Childress on both the NASCAR Busch Series and Winston Cup Series, the GM Goodrich Chevrolet driver maintained his focus, scoring six top 10 finishes during the season's first half, including a seventh at Texas in April and a second at Charlotte in May. While fellow Raybestos Rookie of the Year candidates Kurt Busch, Casey Atwood, Ron Hornaday, Jason Lettler, and Andy Houston proved worthy, Harvick squeezed to victory at the inaugural race at Chicagoland, adding to his rookie-leading 17th Rookie of the Race honors. Runner-up showings at Bristol in August and Richmond in September solidified Harvick as a Winston Cup star. With crew chief Kevin Hamlin by his side, Harvick rallied to his sixth top three finish of the season at Atlanta in November, distinguishing Harvick as the first driver in NASCAR history to capture the Busch Series championship while finishing in the top 10 of the Winston Cup Series standings. Collecting two wins, six top fives, and 16 top tens, please welcome driver of the Richard Childress-owned GM Goodrich Chevrolet. From Bakersfield, California, our 2001 Raybestos Rookie of the Year, Kevin Harvick. Kevin, it has been quite a year. Let's see, you got married, then you won the NASCAR Busch Series Championship. You got another little award coming up here in just a minute from now that I'll let somebody else talk about, and you finished with only 35 races, ninth in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings this year. It's truly been a remarkable, remarkable year for you. I have to tell the story. Next year, hopefully he'll feel like he's on vacation when there's really only one series to run. But he's not known by everybody yet. My wife was riding down in the elevator earlier with him tonight, and she got on, and a number of people from Richard Childress Racing were there. And she said hello to people, and she turned to Kevin and said, 35, please. Literally thinking he was the elevator operator. And he complied, so hopefully people will know who you are now, particularly my wife, wherever she's sitting out there. Congratulations on a ninth place finish. It's been a remarkable year for you. I've got not only your ninth place award, but also a check from you from NASCAR and Winston in the amount of $484,469.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
You can't speak yet. Quiet. This is part of your rookie stripe. You have to know when you're supposed to talk and when you're not. Here to present, let me see that again.
Well, I brought this just in case I had any mistakes. So I'm just gonna put this on the front of the podium. Last time I can use this for an excuse.
All right, well, here's your last official act as a rookie. Here to present the Raybestos Rookie of the Year Award, please welcome the Vice President of Marketing for Dana Brake and Chassis, Mr. Kevin Judge.
Good evening, and thank you, Alan. On behalf of Raybestos, the official brakes of NASCAR and the Dana Corporation, it is with great pleasure that I present the 2001 Raybestos Rookie of the Year Award of $50,000 and an original Jeannie Barnes portrait to Kevin Harvick. Kevin would be first to tell you that he did not replace the legendary Dale Earnhardt, a former rookie himself, but he just took over the driver's seat in a time of need at Richard Childress Racing. I think all of you would agree with me, like our friends here in New York and all that they have been through, Kevin has done an outstanding job this year. Kevin, on behalf of Raybestos and NASCAR, congratulations on a tremendous rookie year.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, if I mess up, I got an excuse sitting on the front, so built in. I want to thank Winston and Raybestos for everything they do for our series and support everything that we do to the fullest extent. When this year started, the two biggest things I had on my to-do list were to get married and win the Busch Series Championship. Thankfully, I can put a check mark beside both of those things. But by standing here in front of you, something more got added to my list this year, under circumstances none of us could ever imagine. Since I was a kid, it was always my dream to race with Dale Earnhardt. And when the opportunity came from RCR to be his teammate, even though it was in the Busch Series, I can't tell you what that meant. Me, this punk kid, would be driving for the same team as the greatest stock car driver to ever sit in the seat of a race car. My dream to race with my hero was taken away from me for reasons none of us will ever understand. But what he and Richard had built over the years was strong enough to give a no-name rookie like me the confidence to go out and race how I wanted to race. I want to thank Richard for putting up with me and Judy for putting up with it all. They believe I had what it takes to compete with the best of the best. I know there had to be times when you questioned your decision because I didn't always do and say the right things, and my competitive spirit pushed things to the edge. But I hope you know how proud and honored I am to drive your race cars. A big thanks to everyone at RCR, and especially your families, for understanding the circumstances of running both series and pulling together as one. And Kevin Hamlin, thank you for toughing it out with me. Your experience taught me a lot this year, whether I wanted to admit it or not. We couldn't have crisscrossed the country and logged more than 21,000 miles on the racetrack this year without the help of our sponsors, but I still haven't found a place to cash in my RCR frequent flyer miles yet. Thank you to GM Goodrich, AC Delco, Chevrolet, Sonic, Snap-on, Bass Pro Shops, Realtree, Hershey, Purdue Chicken, Coca-Cola, Goodyear, Van Camp's Beans, Nabisco, Action, Safety Clean, Ronnie Hopkins Chaskis, and Unical. Thanks to NASCAR for giving us all the opportunity to do what we love to do. Darby, you might want to keep my seat warm in the big red trailer. Even though the yellow stripe is gone, I'm sure you'll be seeing me soon. I want to thank all the race fans for standing behind us. You've made it easier for us to come to the racetrack every weekend. And I promise I'm getting to your fan mail as quick as I can. A special thank you to my best friend, Delana, who stood beside me through all the flights, the races, the people, the ups, the downs, and the times I should have shut my mouth, and the times when things were going right. I love you, and I promise I'll take you on a honeymoon that's not in Atlanta. To Jeff Gordon, congratulations on a championship year. I only hope our Goodrich team can be as fortunate in the years to come. But you know, there's plenty of other places to sit around here. Teresa, Carrie, Dale Jr., Kelly, and Taylor, you've had an unbelievably tough year, and I admire your strength and determination and appreciate the support you've given not only to myself, but also the 29 car. On behalf of myself and everyone at RCR, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and see you in Daytona.
Take that rookie stripe with you, Kevin. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is on stage in just a moment.
TNT detects a glitch in the system.
The Matrix, three nights in a row.
The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us.
One weekend.
Buckle your seatbelt door.
One network.
Because Candace is going by now.
Three mind-bending trips into The Matrix. Beginning next Friday night, see the network television premiere of The Matrix. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night starting at 8. Once inside, you can't get enough. See it exclusively on TNT. We know drama.
Hey, Dad, what's that?
That's a pink flamingo.
What's that?
Bullfrog.
What's that?
That, son, is a Chevy Monte Carlo.
If you want to see 700 horses under a hood, spend a day by the lake at the famous Daytona Infield. But bring your Visa card, the official card of NASCAR.
Isn't nature great?
Visa, it's everywhere NASCAR fans want to be.
At the Home Depot, we're driving down the cost of home improvement with a new program to make low prices even lower. With special buys and new lower prices all over the store and at HomeDepot.com. Just look for the hammer symbol. It means we've got lower prices nailed.
Your home is a reflection of you, of your world, and your place in it. So if you want to put digital TV entertainment in your home, why put this stuff on top of it? Comcast Digital Cable gives you all this on your TV without a satellite dish on your roof. So your beautiful home is still your beautiful home. Comcast Digital Cable.
Are you getting ready to buy a home? Or you'd like to sell yours? Or maybe like thousands of other people, you just enjoy looking? The Home Center Network is Middle Tennessee's best resource for homeowners.
And I'll have to say, the first weekend that one of my listings went on the Home Center Network, I had 9 calls from that.
The Home Center Network is available 7 days a week, and be sure to check out our listings in the City Paper. Join us every morning, 8 to 11 a.m. on Comcast Channel 75.
Unbelievable.
All I need is a miracle. All I need is you. All I need is a miracle.
to say we meet our eighth place finisher in the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series, driver of the number 8 Budweiser Chevrolet, Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Entering his sophomore season, this third-generation driver quickly established himself as a NASCAR force of the present and future. An emotional runner-up finish at the season-opening Daytona 500 served as a harbinger of things to come. In April, Earnhardt Jr. lassoed his first Bud pole of the season at Texas. The two-time NASCAR Busch Series champion backed up his Lone Star State performance with 4 top 8 finishes over the next 6 events, including third-place efforts at California in April and Dover Downs in June. Earnhardt Jr. commenced the season's second half in dramatic style, driving to an impressive victory under the lights at Daytona. A 9th-place effort at New Hampshire and a 2nd-place performance at Pocono completed a July in which Earnhardt Jr. and crew chief Tony Urey procured 3 top 9s in 4 starts. In September, Earnhardt Jr. and his Budweiser Chevrolet charged to the checkers and celebrated America at Dover Downs. And in October, Earnhardt drafted past all challengers and cashed in on a Winston No Bull $5 million bonus at Talladega. Tapping 3 wins, 9 top 5s, and 15 top 10s, please welcome driver of the Dale Earnhardt Incorporated-owned Budweiser Chevrolet from Kannapolis, North Carolina, Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Dale, apparently you never heard about the sophomore slump that's supposed to impact all the second-year teams. It's been a remarkable year for you. But actually, you know, you've had an awful lot to deal with this year, and I think what impressed everybody is how you stayed focused on your racing and the kind of composure and grace that you showed throughout the year. It's been a terrific year, and we've all been proud of you. It's my pleasure on behalf of NASCAR and on behalf of Winston to present you with your trophy for your 8th-place finish, and also with a check. 2 checks. The first is for that 8th-place finish in the amount of $441,715, but there's a little extra in there, that $1 million you got in the Winston No Bull 5 win in Talladega, for a total of $1.4 million. Congratulations.
Good evening. Congratulations, Jeff. Have fun with that. you know, you get up here and you do your best not to forget somebody, and it's a hell of a responsibility to put on just one man, and I can't imagine what Jeff went through trying to write his speech, but as I stand on stage here tonight and reflect on the past season, I'm overcome with grief and happiness. All of us at DEI are very proud of our performance this year, and we feel like it's a cornerstone toward the future of our team in the Winston Cup Series. In losing my father and our leader at DEI, I cannot say enough about everyone's persistence and determination, and I want to thank everyone at DEI for their immeasurable efforts. To the many employees directly involved with the number 8 car, a big thanks to you. Our race cars practically drove themselves sometimes, but I still maintain the argument that I'm at least worth 5 spots. Seriously though, you guys are a group that are unstoppable, and I'm lucky to be driving your race cars. I want to thank my mother and my sister, along with everyone at JR Motorsports, for making life easier. And to the Dirty Mo Posse, you are the shiznit. The same goes for many others throughout our inner circle, such as sponsors like Budweiser, Remington, Snap-on, Nabisco, and Outlaw. Your patience and support will surely pay off with great success and championships in the near future. I give a special thanks to Budweiser for surrounding me with well-qualified and diligent personnel. Tim Schuler, Jade Gerst, Joe Glenn, and Eric Howell, you are great friends. Within the sport itself, there are many companies that complete our program that we must acknowledge. Winston, thanks for everything you do, especially the $1 million bonus. Chevy, Unical, and Goodyear, your never-ending involvement not only complements our efforts, but improves the sport as well. As for NASCAR and its many employees and leaders, I must commend you on your strength and stronghold attitude throughout the year's many ups and downs. Several individuals within this organization held the sport solely on their shoulders at many times. I enjoy being a part of this business and feel confident in its future. This year was over before many of us could catch our breaths, and we'll be testing for the next season very soon. As much of a blur as the season seems, it's one I will force my mind to maintain in memory. This year I battled for wins with the champions of our sport, and after each race I missed my father's approval very much. Whether they know it or not, many of the drivers filled that void. Tony Urie did double duty as well, offering fatherly advice at any moment. He is a great man and the very core of the Bud team's success. Teresa Earnhardt is simply the Amelia Earhart of my life. Her leadership within DEI is dead strong and inspiring. It's really overwhelming being one lone man giving this speech, when in truth there are many who contributed. Whether it's Brian Cram slaving over mounting one of my seats or my Uncle Randy checking parts inventory, their thoughts will not be voiced because tonight we leave for the loot for eighth place. But one day soon, the Bud team will headline this joint, and they will help me write that speech. Thank you. Good night.
Well done, Dale. Now let's meet our seventh place finisher, driver of the number 2 Penske Racing South Miller Lite Ford, the 1989 NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Rusty Wallace.
Entering his 17th full season, the 1989 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion made an immediate impact in 2001, racing to a third-place finish in the season-opening Daytona 500. After back-to-back top 10 efforts at Darlington and Bristol in March, Wallace, with the assistance of crew chief Robin Pemberton, motored to his 54th career victory at California in April. At Richmond, the senior of the Wallace brothers dominated, leading the most laps, only to settle for third after a late race encounter. As summer set in, Wallace and his Miller Lite Ford wheeled to top 5 finishes at Sears Point in June, Daytona and Pocono in July, Indianapolis and Bristol in August, and again at Richmond in September. During the season's final stretch, Wallace powered to top 7 efforts at Kansas and Charlotte, paving the way for his 9th consecutive top 10 appearance in the season-ending NASCAR Winston Cup Series standings. Tabulating 1 win, 8 top 5s, and 14 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Roger Penske-owned Miller Lite Ford from St. Louis, Missouri, Rusty Wallace.
Rusty, I don't think there's anybody in this house that knows more about the importance of consistency than you do. And for all your team does, there are 3 figures I think bear a little bit of repeating tonight. The first is, this is the 16th year in a row that Rusty has had at least 1 win in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series, a pretty remarkable record. The second is, it's the 14th time that he's been up here on this stage, and more importantly, the third number, the 9th consecutive year that you've been on this stage with a top 10 finish. That's consistency. It's my great pleasure on behalf of R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Winston, and NASCAR to present you with your trophy for this year's 7th place finish and a check in the amount of $514,946.
Boy, that's a lot of money, I'll tell you. That's a lot more than it was last year. I'd like to thank R.J. Reynolds for everything they do. You guys are great. I mean, supporting our sport the way you do for year after year, we really, really appreciate it. You know, Jeff, what can I say about you? I used to hate you, now I love you. It's an incredible feat to win 4 championships at your young age. And Rick Hendrick, you guys are awesome. I just really congratulate your team. Job well done. Well, you know, 2001 was not too good a year in my mind. You know, with the loss of my great friend Dale Earnhardt in Daytona, I just didn't think it ever happened. You know, all the crashes I had, the crashes he had, and it happened. I just couldn't believe it. And I wake up every day and I go to bed every night thinking about it. I still can't get it out of my mind. He was my hero. He really was, besides my father, and it's a tough loss. September 11th, that was something. I was out in California visiting some friends, and I woke up that morning, my daughter called me up and said, "Dad, you gotta look at the TV set." I couldn't believe what I was seeing there. But, you know, I think about it, and it's just something I'll never, ever forget the rest of my life. But you know what? On a positive side, this was one of the best years for NASCAR. I would personally like to thank NBC, TNT, Fox, and FX for taking our sport to a whole new level we thought we'd never be to. Thank you very much. You know, this was a big year for me personally. I pride myself in performance and winning, and I was really proud to win that 16th consecutive win this year by winning the California 500. It was really important to me. But you know, the main reason I'm here tonight is to thank everybody who made this whole year possible for us. So if you bear with me for a minute, it's a lot of sponsors, but I need to recognize every single one of them. All my friends, the Miller Brewing Company, for being with us so long, ExxonMobil, Ford Motor Company, PPG, Lennox Heating and Cooling, Mead Papers, the United Association of Plumbers and Pipefitters, Bosch Spark Plugs, Mazak, Goodyear Tire Rubber Company, Penske Auto Centers, Snap-on Tools, the United Auto Group, and Penske Truck Leasing. These guys supplied a lot of money to get these old hot rods running. Now, some companies I personally do business with I want to thank: Bombardier Learjet, Oakley Sunglasses, Haribo Gummer Candies, Amtrak Cheerings, Nikon Optics, Utz Quality Snacks, Jack Blink's Beef Jerky, Carnival Cruise Lines, Polaris Watercraft, AT&T, and Motorola. I told you it was a lot. You know, next, I'd like to thank the entire staff at NASCAR. I tell you what, if I'm up in that trailer a lot, screaming and hollering at them, but they take it all the time, and they've led our sport to what it is today, and I really appreciate everybody at NASCAR. Well, now we get to the guys that really make the car run. I'd like to thank my entire Robin Pemberton-led race team. Those guys are great, and we ran super good this year. I'd also like to thank the guys at Penske Engine Company. We had some great horsepower this year. And you know, next year, you're gonna be hearing about my teammate a lot, Ryan Newman. This guy's here, he's for real, he's gonna win some races. You know, there's two guys in my life that have done a whole lot for me, and I'd like to recognize them. My car owner, Roger Penske, and my other car owner, Don Miller. These guys have been with me forever and ever. I'd also like to thank our general manager, John Erickson, along with Walter Zarnicke, Greg Penske, Tom Roberts, Wally McCarty, Joris Kearns, and everybody for a job well done. Now I'd like to recognize Fred Wagonalls with Action Performance, the guy who makes the best merchandise in the world for our fans. Fred, thank you very much for the job you do. And speaking of fans, I want to thank every fan out there that supported this year and supported NASCAR, myself and that number two car. You guys are awesome. I'd also like to recognize my staff at Rusty Wallace Incorporated, business manager Dick Pacer, director of marketing Tom Knox, Tom Polanski, John Pacer, Karen Smith, Kim Franklin, Stella Pacer, our chief pilot, Bill Brooks, Roland Carroll, and Ron Garrell. Well, I'll tell you what, last but never least, I want to thank my entire family, my wife, Patty, my sons, Greg, Stephen, and my daughter, Katie. Because I'll tell you what, without their support, this thing would be unbearable, the schedule we keep. Well, everybody, I've talked long enough, and now I'm getting ready to go to Daytona and try to win a race. And I know next year is going to be a great year for Team Penske. Thank you.
Thank you, Rusty. We'll continue meeting our top 10 drivers in a moment, and also coming up a little later, a very special performance by Mr. Garth Brooks.
Welcome.
This is Santa's Workshop 2001. Billions of wish lists come in from around the world, and UPS helps us navigate supply chain management issues.
Oh, coal comes in from the Balkans for the naughty.
Boy band figurines come in from Japan for the nice.
Think about the logistics on that one.
We have been a successful brand for centuries now, and for a number of years, UPS has been an invaluable partner. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus, and he's working with UPS.
No.
Safe figure, let me one. Safe figure, let me one. Hello, Salaman.
Who can also
Family vacation on the wings of Goodyear.
We're here pitting the new Dremel Advantage rotary saw against the competition to see which tool best handles all sawing conditions. Unlike some others, the Dremel Advantage hugs the curves. Its powerful motor blasts through tile and other tough surfaces. Yet its unique variable speed adjustment handles everything from plexiglass to laminates and drywall. And with 35,000 RPM, it'll slice through materials up to 1 inch thick. So no matter what you're cutting, you always win. The new Dremel Advantage. Drive the power. Celebrating by Team Monte Carlo.
Now the first thing you've got to do is jump up here and scream and yell, woo! Make sure your hat guy forms them first so you don't end up looking like a dork. Now when somebody hands you one of these babies, make sure you say thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, man, don't eat the check.
Want to be like Jeff Gordon? Drive the Chevy Monte Carlo. The cars more champions depend on. Chevy will be there.
This weekend, all the drama is on TNT. Saturday night at 8, watch Judy Garland in the timeless classic that proves there's no place like home. Don't miss The Wizard of Oz. And Sunday night at 8, bring the family together for this season's holiday event. See Whoopi Goldberg in the world premiere of Call Me Claus. Saturday night, watch The Wizard of Oz. And Sunday night, see Call Me Claus. Every weekend, all the drama, all weekend long is on TNT.
I began racing 1982. I was 15 years old with the dream of winning a Winston Cup race. And by God, we did it today.
Certainly one of the most magical moments of the season, Ricky Craven earning his first Winston Cup victory. The Bill France Award of Excellence is a very special award. The list of past recipients reads like a who's who of NASCAR. To present the award, please welcome the chairman of NASCAR, Mr. Bill France.
Thank you very much, and good evening, everyone. Our Award of Excellence is not presented every year. It is only presented when a company or individual goes above and beyond the 24-hour day devotion required to be successful in NASCAR. This year's recipient has been a tireless contributor to our sport for more than a decade. His willingness to share ideas in the interest of safety, and has been particularly outstanding. He was a key player in the development of our roof flaps for our cars, not to mention many other innovative safety measures. This car owner joins an elite group that has been selected to receive the Award of Excellence. Please join me in congratulating a most deserving individual, the 2001 recipient of the Bill France Award of Excellence, Mr. Jack Roush. It took you by surprise, didn't it?
My turkey is colder than the one I had on Thursday.
Well, I'm glad we took you by surprise, because you sure take me by surprise about 25 times a year when you walk up in that office of that trailer.
You know, When I was watching everybody come up here with all their speeches and all their pleasantries and the things that happened, I said, you know, 14 years I've been doing this. It's a lot of fun. I got knots all over my head. One or two parts of my body are not nearly as comfortable as they used to be. But I feel a lot like Winston Churchill, you know, in one of his speeches when, except mine's in reverse. I feel like that never in the history of Winston Cup racing has any car owner done so little with so much for so long. I apologize and I'll do better.
Mr. France, thank you. Jack, congratulations. Now let's continue recognizing this year's top 10 drivers. Our sixth place finisher is the driver of the number 18 Interstate Batteries Pontiac, the 2000 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, Bobby Labonte.
Falling short of defending his 2000 NASCAR Winston Cup Series title, the Interstate Batteries Pontiac driver did charge to his fourth consecutive finish among the top 10 in the season-ending standings. An early runner-up performance at Rockingham in February represented one of eight top 10 finishes through the season's first half. After a fifth place at Talladega and a Bud Pole effort at California in April, the Joe Gibbs team roared to a top five under the lights at Daytona. Led by crew chief Jimmy Makar, Labonte stormed the season's second half, highlighted by a thrilling late race victory at Pocono in July, propelling Labonte to a host of top 10 finishes, including a third at Darlington in September, a fourth at Martinsville in October, and an eighth at Homestead, Miami in November. Labonte capped his season by powering to his 18th career NASCAR Winston Cup Series triumph as he outgassed the competition on the final lap at Atlanta. Achieving two wins, nine top fives, and 20 top 10 finishes. Please welcome driver of the Joe Gibbs-owned Interstate Batteries Pontiac from Corpus Christi, Texas, Bobby Labonte.
Bobby, I think coming off a championship year, we all know how frustrated you guys were early in the year. But you know, by the time you won the Pennsylvania 500, it seemed that the number 18 Interstate Batteries team had gotten things back on track, and that's what led you right up here to a sixth place finish. One thing I do want to do with the entire group here tonight is just take a minute and thank you for the outstanding year you provided as the champion for the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. You represented NASCAR, your fellow competitors, RJ Reynolds, extraordinarily well. You were always cheerful. You did a wonderful job, and I personally would like to thank you and offer a round of applause for this great champion. But I know why you like accolades, you really like money, so let's get on. Here is a presentation from both Winston and NASCAR for your finish as in the sixth place this year, your trophy, and most importantly, a check in the amount of $645,528. Right. Congratulations, Bobby.
Thank you. Thanks, Rick.
That's an exciting amount there. You know, it's some ways it doesn't seem like it's been a year since I've been up here, but by the difference in the monies from last year, I can tell it's been a year exactly. But it'll still spin well. Thanks again. You know, I just want to thank R.J. Reynolds again for all your support for the series. It's sure is a great series to be in, and we sure have a lot of fun. Jeff, congratulations on you and your team for winning your fourth championship. You and your team are definitely contenders all year long, and I know that you'll once again be a great champion. 2001 sure was a different year for our race team. We struggled sometimes in races and had some races that we didn't finish. But our team has Jimmy Makar, Mark Cronquist, and everyone at Joe Gibbs Racing on our side. And we have to feel good about how things are handled. When you think about two wins, 20 top 10s, and six in points, it really wasn't a bad year, just a different year. And I like the attitude of everyone at Joe Gibbs Racing. Different just isn't good enough for them. Kick somebody out, I'm sorry. Of course, no good race team can operate without great sponsors. Interstate Batteries, Norm and Tommy Miller, thanks for being with Joe Gibbs Racing for 10 years now. MBNA, Charlie, Rick, you guys are a big part of our program. To AG, Action Performance, Champion Spark Plug, Chef Boyardee, Cintas Uniforms, Circuit City, Coca-Cola, Daewoo, Ditch Witch, whew, I need a caution flag. Anybody? No. EDS, Food Line, Goodyear Tires, Husqvarna, Mac Tools, Nike, Sickens Paint, and Wix Filters. And that's a lot of sponsors. And that's a lot of help for our number 18 Pontiac Grand Prix. Throughout a long season, I'd be remiss if I didn't thank Donna, Tyler, and Madison for being there and for how much I depend on your support. To Tony and all the Home Depot crew, congratulations on a great season, finishing second in points. You guys are true teammates and great friends. The France family and NASCAR, thanks for all you do for us and with us so that we can help keep the sport growing. Finally, more important than in any year in racing, it was a tough year for our country and our sport. We lost a good friend and a great competitor in Daytona this year. As a country, we saw what happened just a few miles from here. I know that we've become more aware of safety issues over the past couple of years. Also, more importantly, we've learned not to rush life, but to value every day, for we're here just a short time. I want to thank Jeff Burton for the idea to come to New York several weeks ago and asking me to join him to meet some of the New York City firefighters and police officers. That was truly a special day. And last but not least, to the fans who continue to come to all the races and support the sport we all love. Thanks and good night.
Coming up in just a moment, a very special tribute to a very exceptional champion.
Holiday season, Garth Brooks is giving Christmas a whole new swing.
I have to find somebody to take my place before midnight on Christmas Eve.
I don't suppose you'd take no for an answer, would you?
Call me Santa, call me Kringle, call me El Saint Nick.
Whoopi Goldberg and Nigel Hawthorne in a movie that finds the true spirit of Christmas with new music from Garth Brooks. Call Me Claus. See the world premiere Sunday at 8, only on TNT.
The Daytona 500 last February and finished second at the 400 in July. Now I'm dreaming about winning the 500 again. My teammate, Dale Jr., may have something to say about it, though. After all, he was second when I won, and in July he won and I was second. To me, that just means it's my turn again.
The Daytona 500, Sunday, February 17th. For tickets, visit our website or call 386-253-RACE.
I'm also going to run the Busch's race Saturday, February the 16th. I've got a great car.
Look, I think I saw my breath.
You didn't see your breath.
I did. I saw it.
Why don't you call Sears?
Maybe I should call.
Brian, I'm cold. You're cold. It's cold.
It's time.
Now's the time to save on Sears installed heating. Get 0% financing until next March on all high-efficiency central heating systems we install. That means no billing, no payments, and no interest until March 2002. Call for a free in-home estimate.
Winner. Don't you just love it?
I'm warming up to it.
We thought we were going to get one of these satellite dishes. You know, sounded pretty cool.
They said I could get my local channels.
A few
Local channels.
But not all of them.
What about the WB?
I don't get UPN.
The ones that handle the schools, the townships.
I don't even get my local PBS station.
And then they tell me I have to have a phone line tied up to the receiver.
Now, why do they need my phone line going into their satellite receiver?
It creeps me out to think that somebody is, like, connected to my phone line.
Satellite TV isn't all it's dished up to be.
I don't think they mention that in the ad.
Welcome back to New York City. Just a few blocks from here, the famous Christmas tree at 30 Rock, this year adorned in bulbs of red, white, and blue. And here in the Waldorf Astoria, the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Awards ceremony continues. Please join me and welcome once again from NBC News, Brian Williams.
For millions of Americans, for that matter, for NASCAR fans around the world seemed to stop on the last lap of the Daytona 500. It was unusual enough for all of us to watch Dale Earnhardt play defense instead of offense. He knew he didn't have the horses for a late run, and besides, his DEI boys were up front. He could stay back and block. It was also unusual that that vice-like hug around the neck that Michael Waltrip was expecting never came. Richard Childress was expecting one of those as well. Many of you know that hug very well. It just slightly cuts off the circulation. We heard words like serious but stable. We saw no pictures, thankfully. It was horrible for viewers and fans who were left not knowing. Until Mike Helton uttered those words, "We've lost Dale Earnhardt." That night, my 10-year-old son, Douglas, asked me, "Is there any chance that Dale could wake up and that everything would be okay?" Since the great Lee Petty claimed the inaugural award in 1953, the most popular driver award has been highly coveted by all NASCAR drivers. Presented by the National Motorsports Press Association, the award is unique because the fans decide on the recipient by voting on the internet or by phone. As the most popular driver for 2001, the fans have overwhelmingly chosen to honor Dale Earnhardt. To all of those who loved him, all of us who still look for the black number three in the field, if you look real hard, they say you can still see him there. If you listen with us to the following song, well, perhaps you just might feel him here with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, here to remember Dale Earnhardt, Mr. Garth Brooks.
It is not an honor that I deserve to be here. There are people in my entertainment format like Kix Brooks and Steve Warner that follow this stuff a lot closer than I ever would. I'm here to pay tribute, though, to not the driver as much as a great man, a great father, and a great husband. And the only thing I know to do, I don't talk very well, but in my songs, hopefully, we can get something across. This is a song from Tony Arata that's dedicated to everyone that loved this man. The song's called The Dance. Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared. The stars above, and for a moment, all the world was right. How could I have known you'd ever say goodbye? And now, glad I didn't know the way it all would end.
that I hate to lose the day. Holding you, I held everything for a moment. Wasn't I lucky? But if I'd only known how the king would fall, he used to say, no, I might have changed it all. And now,
Miss Teresa Earnhardt.
Well, maybe you've missed me a little bit as much as I've missed you all. thank you so much. It's not easy to choose words for someone else, especially when that someone else is Dale Earnhardt. I'm pleased that we're all able to put another honor in the books for Dale. He is finally, officially, the most popular driver. I don't want anyone to be overly upset that he cannot personally receive this award, for the fact of the matter is he knew perfectly well the extent of his popularity, and he actually enjoyed this unofficial honor when he was here with us. And the influence he has on our sport will no doubt live on forever. I don't know if he knew the full extent of the inspiration he provided for us. He still compels and motivates us to achieve more. He is a true American role model, from growing up to personal and professional achievement. And during this difficult time in our nation's history, having a strong role model like Dale Earnhardt is more important than ever. Dale Earnhardt lived an American dream. He worked for it. He paid for it. He was sure of it. He was proud of it. And he enjoyed it. And so did we. Thank you.
Dale Earnhardt changed the game. The sport is different.
Welcome.
Alan Bestwick with Benny Parsons here to tell you about this year's must-have gift from UMI, the NASCAR Winston Cup Yearbook.
Alan, this year's edition is the biggest ever. It includes a special section celebrating 30 years of NASCAR Winston Cup champions. Names like Earnhardt, Petty, Gordon, and even me.
The NASCAR Winston Cup Yearbook is the perfect Christmas gift. It's a true racing collectible. This is the book that's presented at the banquet each year. It's never reprinted, not available in any bookstore, and filled with 300 pages of the best images of NASCAR Winston Cup season, bound with a rich bonded leather cover.
This book is a great gift, but only limited numbers are available to the public. And at $39.95, they sell out fast. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
When you purchase your NASCAR Winston Cup yearbook and the official NASCAR Preview magazine, you get this free commemorative 30 years of Winston Cup champion CD. Ask your operator for details. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
Limited numbers available. Call now.
Fishing every weekend, right? You never catch a thing.
It's not a bad
ottoman.
What is going on?
Armoire.
Furniture. Why is there furniture?
Chafing dish.
Chafing dish.
I thought I told you to strap everything down.
Coffee table.
Morning commute.
Couch.
On the wings of Goodyear.
This is Santa's Workshop 2001. Billions of wish lists come in from around the world, and UPS helps us navigate supply chain management issues.
Oh, coal comes in from the Balkans for the naughty.
Boy band figurines come in from Japan for the nice.
Think about the logistics on that one.
We have been a successful brand for centuries now, and for a number of years, UPS has been an invaluable partner. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus, and he's working with UPS.
Store up on great holiday gifts at Pep Boys. Get custom alloy wheels from only $49 each and add a set of 40,000-mile truck tires from just $49.99 each. Get your holiday gifts now at Pep Boys. Store up on great holiday gifts at Pep Boys. Buy a Delta aluminum toolbox, a Weston grill guard or step bar, or some cool performance accessories like these slick APC taillights. Get your holiday gifts now at Pep Boys.
This holiday season, Garth Brooks is giving Christmas a whole new swing.
I have to find somebody to take my place before midnight on Christmas Eve.
I don't suppose you'd take no for an answer, would you?
Call me Santa, call me Kringle, call me Elsa.
Whoopi Goldberg and Nigel Hawthorne in a movie that finds the true spirit of Christmas with new music from Garth Brooks. Call Me Claus. See the world premiere Sunday at 8, only on TNT.
Hard working,
And welcome back to New York City as the NASCAR 2001 Winston Cup Awards ceremony continues here at the Waldorf Astoria. And Benny, obviously a very emotional tribute to Dale Earnhardt from Garth, and then the appearance of Teresa Earnhardt.
That was unbelievable. I don't know how Teresa had the courage to do what she did. All the ladies in the audience, I saw them start pulling the tissue out of the purse, and Garth just started singing.
It was amazing. The house was very quiet earlier this evening when Garth rehearsed. Right now, the award ceremony is continuing here at the Waldorf. Let's go down to the stage, and here again is Alan Bestwick.
And let's continue recognizing this year's top finishing drivers in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. Finishing fifth, the driver of the number 88 UPS Ford, Dale Jarrett.
Setting out to deliver a second NASCAR Winston Cup Series championship, the 1999 series champion quickly established himself as a title contender. A Bud Pohl qualifying effort backed with a runner-up performance at Las Vegas in March set the stage for an early season surge that saw Jarrett score his third spring victory at Darlington, followed by career first wins at Texas and Martinsville in April. An 18th place effort at Michigan in June cost Jarrett the point lead, but only momentarily, as crew chief Todd Parrott and the UPS Ford team stormed to the top with a fourth place finish at the inaugural race at Chicagoland and a season's fourth victory at New Hampshire in July. While Jarrett's grip on the top slipped, his strong performances maintained. Jarrett's first road course Bud Pohl came at Watkins Glen in August, and his fifth season Bud Pohl at Dover Downs in September represented a season sweep of the top spot at the Monster Mile. In October, Jarrett nearly made it 2-for-2 at Martinsville, finishing just behind Ford mate Ricky Graydon. With a fourth place at Rockingham and an eighth at Atlanta, Dale Jarrett delivered his fifth consecutive top 10 appearance in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series standing. Accumulating four wins, 12 top fives, and 19 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Robert Yates-owned UPS Ford from Hickory, North Carolina, Dale Jarrett.
Dale, by all measures, you've had an extraordinarily strong year, including three wins at tracks that you'd not won at before. But one of those amazing facts that I want to mention to the group as a whole, of course, this is about recognizing the top 10 drivers. This is Dale's seventh consecutive appearance on this stage, not as a top 10 driver, but the seventh consecutive top five finish in the last 7 years. That is incredible consistency, and of course the series rewards that. So other rewards coming from the series for your fifth place finish, we're presenting you with your trophy and also a check from NASCAR in Winston in the amount of $757,876. You can move some packages with that.
Yeah, thank you.
If you're wondering what I was chuckling about, on the front of my envelope it says, "We want you to drive the truck." So I guess we can't get away from it anywhere. Thanks, Rick. And as always, we appreciate everything that Winston and RJ Reynolds have done for our sport over the years. Let me begin by congratulating Jeff Gordon, Robbie Loomis, and Rick Hendrick, and the entire 24 team on an outstanding championship season. You guys are terrific. It has taken total team effort at Robert Yates Racing for us to finish in the top five of the final Winston Cup standings for six consecutive years. I would like to thank Robert and Carolyn Yates, Doug and Whitney Yates, Todd and Debbie Parrott, and all of our dedicated employees and their families for the tremendous effort and sacrifices they make to ensure we put a competitive UPS Ford Taurus on the track each week. This team effort also includes Ricky Rudd and everyone on the Texaco Haviland team. And a quick note to Ricky, I'll be glad to take you to an Outback Steakhouse anytime for your own bloomin' onion and great steak. To make our racing organization possible, it takes many great sponsors. And just in case you have been asleep and didn't catch one of the 88,000 commercials aired, I drive for the people who want me to race the big brown truck. That, of course, is UPS, and I trust you will be using them for all of your shipping needs over the holidays. Associate sponsor Ford Credit donated more than $195,000 this year to the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation. Planters Peanuts, Goodyear, Fleetwood RVs, Bushnell, Bolle, Nike, and Action Performance were also associates this season. Being a member of the Coca-Cola Racing family of drivers is something I've been proud of for a number of years. Speaking of families, I would like to thank my wife, Kelly, my children, and my entire family for their love and support throughout this very difficult year. You're truly an inspiration to me to be the best I can be. Also, congratulations to my son, Jason, on his second place finish in his first year of the ARCA Series and being named Rookie of the Year. I'm very proud of him, son. 2001 was to be the signature year for NASCAR Winston Cup Racing. Our new TV partners, Fox, NBC, and TNT, were taking us to millions of new viewers. Competition was to be closer than ever. New winners were sure to be on the horizon. And no sooner did we get started in February and Michael Waltrip won his first race, the Daytona 500. Our happiness for Michael soon turned to tears as we learned that we had lost our hero and leader, Dale Earnhardt. Now you have all undoubtedly heard many of us call Dale our friend, and I'm sure you may wonder how he could be such a fierce competitor, yet such a good friend to so many people. That's what made Dale Earnhardt so special. Now, I'm only one of many that had the opportunity to see and feel both sides of this truly remarkable champion, and I am thankful for that privilege. And will our sport ever be the same? No. Will we survive and continue to grow? Absolutely, because that is what Dale would tell us to do. Race hard and have fun. There are still many situations I encounter where I ask myself, what advice would Dale have given me? It's these memories of our friendship that I will cherish forever. So in closing, I would like to thank our many loyal fans for their support of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing. I would also ask for your continued prayers for those involved in these September 11th attacks and for our leaders as we continue to recover and rebuild our great nation. I encourage each of you to spend time with your family, enjoy the holiday season, and then let's get ready to race hard and have fun in 2002. God bless you all.
Well done, Dale. Let's stay on the Robert Yates Racing theme for the moment, shall we? Our fourth place finisher in the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series is the driver of the number 28 Texaco Haviland Ford, Ricky Rudd.
Mounting an all-out assault on his first NASCAR Winston Cup, this second year Robert Yates Racing driver began with an impressive fourth place finish at the season opener in Daytona. With a runner-up performance at Martinsville in April, Rudd commenced to post 10 top 10 finishes in 12 starts, including a fifth-place effort at Richmond in May and a second-place showing at Michigan in June. At Pocono, Rudd tapped his sole Bud pole of 2001 and promptly drove on to procure his first victory since 1998. Back-to-back third-place runs at Chicagoland and New Hampshire in July served notice that Ricky Rudd, crew chief Michael McSwain, and the Texaco Haviland Ford were title contenders. In September, Rudd revisited Victory Lane, this time with flair at Richmond. Rudd solidified his Richmond cheer with consecutive third-place endeavors at Dover Downs and Kansas in September. While a cool October dashed Rudd's title hopes, the 1977 Rebestos Rookie of the Year proved his veteran poise with a third-place result at Phoenix and an eighth-place posting at Rockingham, earning his 18th top 10 finish in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series standings. Scoring two victories, 14 top fives, and 22 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Robert Yates owned Texaco Haviland Ford from Chesapeake, Virginia, Ricky Rudd.
Ricky, I have to tell you, you and the 28 team came back with a vengeance this year. Week in and week out, it seemed like you were one of the cars that everybody knew they had to beat. And all the way through to the end of the season, I know Jeff Gordon kept looking in that rearview mirror saying, I wish this guy would go away. You kept the pressure on. Congratulations on your fourth place finish this year in the point standings. I've got here for you your trophy and a check from NASCAR and Winston in the amount of $880,224. Congratulations, Ricky.
Appreciate that, Rick. Y'all bear with me a little bit. My voice is about gone here. I actually had a better speech prepared than Dale Jarrett did a while ago, but my voice has got me, so I'm going to have to cut it short tonight. Now, I'd just like to say, first of all, it's great to be with Robert Yates Racing. We've had a tremendous year. It's great to have a teammate like Dale Jarrett. Truly enjoy each other's professionalism on the racetrack. He's been a big inspiration to me. And by the way, Dale, I'm not sure where you're sitting at. You're probably close in here. I've got enough money, I can buy my own blooming onion. Thank you. But anyway, it was kind of a strange year for us. You know, we came out of the box and we got behind a little bit in the beginning of the season, had a few mechanical failures and rebounded, came back strong, came back and finally got to the point we could just barely make out and see the back of Jeff's bumper. He was up front all year long and we finally got ourselves into second place there. And tried to put a little pressure on Jeff. We just didn't have much luck. We broke a few things there late in the season and just couldn't seem to make it happen. But awfully proud of this Robert Yates Texaco Avalon race team. They took this Taurus and kept me up front all year. Every race car driver's dream is to get in a race car that has the potential to win each and every race. And these guys did that for me. So my hat's off to them. Thank them very much. The motor department at Robert Yates Racing, second to none. These guys do a great job. Week in and week out. So, you know, without that horsepower every week, we wouldn't have been able to accomplish the things we did. I guess with that, I'd just like to go down a real very quick list. Everybody's got their list. Our thank yous go out to obviously Texaco, Haviland, Ford, Coca-Cola, Ray Bestas, Fleetwood, Winston, NASCAR, the fans, and mostly my wife Linda and our son Landon, who couldn't be here tonight, that put up with this every week in and week out. So again, thanks to all you guys. And just a real quick story, we had a couple of wins slip away from us this year, so it's kind of hard to take. Rusty and I have had the habit of sort of running into each other all year long, not really sure why. And to top it off, this is no lies, true story, Rusty's sitting right behind me in our seats right here. And a while ago, during the intermission, we both got up at the same time and we bumped heads. Honest story. Again, just we got a few crew members who are a little bit banged up and sore at the end of the season. They sort of took a hard hit on pit road. But these guys are tough. It's amazing. All these guys have come back. Certainly they're bruised and banged up a little bit. Bobby, our tire changer, who's banged up the most, he's going to be okay. He's out hard-headed as ever. He's out driving back and forth to the shop occasionally and not paying attention to the doctors. And that, but you'd have to know Bobby to understand that's just Bobby. But we're real lucky to have these guys back. Looking forward to next year. Changes on our car next year. I'm not really quite sure how this thing's going to look yet. It's going to be exciting, though. We've got Chevron Texaco with Haviland's going to be back with us. So we're real excited about it and looking forward to Daytona. Jeff Gordon, you guys, you're all the champions. You deserve it. Robbie Loomis, real quick story. These guys, we were fighting these guys most of the year. Tell you the class act these guys are. We get to Phoenix, Arizona. We're not having a good weekend. We're not running that well. We qualified like 30th in practice. Robbie, these guys are parked next to us. Look over there and said, man, you guys need a little help. I'm not trying to tell you what to do, but you might want to think about this spring and this sway bar and that shock absorber. Helped us. We went out there and finished third that day. So my hat's off to these guys. By the way, that's the last help we're going to get because I think Jeff finished fourth that day or something. So thank y'all. Don't want to forget Michael McSwain, crew chief of the year. Thank you.
What did he forget, Jeff? Did he leave the check up there? Oh, okay. He's pointing. You forgot something. His setup sheet they took? Okay, never mind. Let's continue now with our third place driver, who wheeled the number 40 Coors Light Dodge this season to great success, Sterling Marlin.
Teaming with Chip Ganassi, the son of legendary NASCAR Winston Cup driver Cuckoo Marlin welcomed the return of Dodge by pushing play on his second best finish in the season-ending championship standings. A season-long contender for his first Winston Cup, Marlin was strong from the start, racing to four top eight finishes in the season's first five events, including a third place at Las Vegas and a fifth at Darlington. Five more top 10 efforts through June, highlighted by a third place at Michigan, set the stage for Marlin's first Bud Bowl at Daytona in July. a runner-up performance at the Brickyard in August served notice that Dodge was on the verge of victory. 2 weeks later at Michigan, Marlin and crew chief Lee McCall returned Dodge to victory lane, celebrating Dodge's first Winston Cup Series victory since 1977. Marlin and the Coors Light team returned to victory lane in October, leading the most laps along the way at Charlotte. A fifth at Homestead, Miami, and a runner-up effort at Atlanta in November earned Marlin his first top five ranking since 1995. Accruing two wins, 12 top fives, and 20 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Chip Ganassi-owned Coors Light Dodge from Columbia, Tennessee, Sterling Marlin.
Sterling, when you talk about consistency in this spirit, in this season and series, the Coors Light team has really got to be a model. Now you think about this, this is the first year back for Dodge, it's the first year with Chip Ganassi Racing, and when you look at the series points after each of 34 out of 36 races this year, you were in the top five. There were only two races where you didn't end up being in the top five and you took a look at the total series standing. That is absolutely incredible. Congratulations, obviously, on what led to the number three finish this year in the NASCAR Winston Cup points. We've got for you your trophy and a check, and now we're heading into seven figures in the amount of $1,077,572. Congratulations, Sterling.
Thanks, Rick. That's a long way from $1,000 win 50-lap shows in Nashville, Tennessee about 20 years ago. Man. Jeff, congratulations on a great year, and Rick and Robbie, you guys are class act, and y'all gonna be tough to beat again next year, but we're gonna be right behind you trying to hang on to you. Coming into this season with a new car owner and a new manufacturer, I'm sure a lot of people didn't expect us to do so well. But after testing in November, I felt like we had a good race team and race cars, and the cars were fast right out of the box. I felt like we had what it takes to be a top five team. I've had a ball this season. It's been one of my best so far, and there are a lot of people to thank for it. First, I would like to thank owners Chip Ganassi and Felix Sabatis. These guys gave us the tools we needed to win races and be championship contenders. I'm glad Chip and Felix gave me the opportunity to drive their race cars this year. Also, I would like to thank my team managers, Andy Graves and Tony Glover, and my crew chief, Lee McCall. I've known Tony and Andy for a long time, and I'm glad to be working with both of them. Lee, you did a great job this year for being a rookie crew chief. Thanks, pal. I also like to thank Ernie Elliott and all them guys down in Dawsonville, Georgia, Concord, North Carolina. They had some great racing engines, and man, they run good. I'd also like to thank all the guys back at the shop. They've done a great job all year. They put in a lot of hours and hard work and give us great race cars each weekend. Thanks, guys. I can't say enough about our sponsor, Coors Light. I've been with these guys since 1997. I have to thank them for giving us the best looking car we got. And for sticking best looking car on the racetrack and for sticking with us through thick and thin. I was excited about being with the new manufacturer this season. Dodge came into this sport strong and gave us plenty of support. I'm still wondering where my Viper is, Wildburger. He showed up yet. I also like to thank my other sponsors, Boss, Snap-on, Sterling Trucks, Ken Metal, Target, and Lincoln Electric. I would also like to thank Goodyear for some great tires this year. Thank Winston for all they do for us. They've been through with us through thick and thin since 71, I guess. And thanks NASCAR for everything they've done all these years. Last but not least, I'd like to thank Miss Paula for taking care of me. Together we've seen this sport grow a lot. And we've come a long way since driving a Chevette to and from the races 20 years ago, 25, whatever it was. I'd like to say hello to my kids, Stephen and Sully, my dad back home. I'd also like to thank the fans for all the support throughout these years. And we'll try to see you up here next year. Thanks.
The second place driver, Tony Stewart, will move to the stage shortly when we continue with the NASCAR Winston Cup Series awards ceremony from inside the Waldorf Astoria. Do you know there are about 1,000 fans outside on the street just waiting to get a glimpse of this place? Wow, in New York.
I'm a Stewart fan. She's a... Junior fan, but Jeff Gordon's great too.
Rusty Wallace, of course. Little odds with my son, but that's okay.
Tony Stewart, Ricky Rudd. Any of them is great.
Yeah.
I actually have Faye Earnhardt Jr.'s autograph right on my TV set when he showed up on Wall Street last year. That was my dream come true.
Junior's going to be the champ next year. Joey in South Jersey. You got it.
The most acclaimed series on TV, Law and Order, is now on TNT.
You have to talk to me.
The girl is just violent, Jack.
Don't miss back-to-back episodes of Law and Order, Monday and Tuesday nights, starting at 8 on TNT.
One weekend, one network, three mind-bending trips into The Matrix. Beginning next Friday night, see the network television premiere of The Matrix. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night, starting at 8, exclusively on TNT.
At the Home Depot, we're driving down the cost of home improvement with a new program to make low prices even lower. With special buys and new lower prices all over the store and at HomeDepot.com. Just look for the hammer symbol. It means we've got lower prices nailed.
Alan Bestwick with Benny Parsons here to tell you about this year's must-have gift from UMI, the NASCAR Winston Cup yearbook.
Alan, this year's edition is the biggest ever. It includes a special section celebrating 30 years of NASCAR Winston Cup champions. Names like Earnhardt, Petty, Gordon, and even me.
The NASCAR Winston Cup yearbook is the perfect Christmas gift. It's a true racing collectible. This is the book that's presented at the banquet each year. It's never reprinted, not available in any bookstore, and filled with 300 pages of the best images of the NASCAR Winston Cup season, bound with a rich bonded leather cover.
This book is a great gift, but only limited numbers are available to the public. And at $39.95, they sell out fast. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
When you purchase your NASCAR Winston Cup yearbook and the official NASCAR Preview magazine, you get this free commemorative 30 years of Winston Cup champion CD. Ask your operator for details. Call 1-800-922-WCUP.
Limited numbers available. Call now.
There's your Tuesday surprise!
What is?
Dispatch, Wendy's Kissable Agents!
A cheeseburger!
And Frosties!
Nice hair.
Wendy's Kids Meals. Great food, cool toy, like this.
All you boys and girls will be thrilled to learn. You can come to Wendy's for the Grinch's return. There's a Grinch with a really big heart. Two Grinch games. Ready? Start. There's a spinner. It's Max. And a sleigh that makes tracks. There's one Grinch toy in every Wendy's Kids Meal you buy. You can collect all five.
The Cougars come to Evans to take on the Bulldogs. You can catch a rear of the game at 9 p.m. Eastern this Tuesday. Available only on Comcast Sports Southeast. Georgia hosts Houston. Available only on CSS. Your source for sports in the Southeast.
Okay, so we had a bunch of really good burnouts and one that didn't quite make it. He did a lot of other things really good, though, this year, so we'll let him slide with that. Now let's meet our runner-up in the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship, the driver of the number 20 Home Depot Pontiac for Joe Gibbs, Tony Stewart.
After a challenging start to the season, the 1999 Raybestos Rookie of the Year rebuilt his season with a sequence of impressive results, which included a runner-up finish at Talladega and a fourth at California in April, leading to an exciting victory at Richmond in May. A third-place performance at Charlotte in May set the stage for Stewart's inaugural road course triumph at Sears Point in June, representing the first non-oval win for car owner Joe Gibbs and crew chief Greg Zivadelli. After a fifth at New Hampshire and a third at Pocono in July, the Home Depot Pontiac team rocketed to near the top of the series standings with an impressive August victory under the lights at Bristol. Stewart's Bristol Bash marked a streak of 9 top 8 finishes in 10 starts, including second place finishes at Charlotte and Talladega in October. Concluding the season with a fifth place showing at Phoenix, a seventh at Rockingham, and a fifth at New Hampshire, Tony Stewart has secured his highest ever ranking in the season-ending NASCAR Winston Cup Series standings. Posting 3 victories, 15 top 5s, and 22 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Joe Gibbs-owned Home Depot Pontiac from Rushville, Indiana, Tony Stewart.
Wow, Tony. This is your third season, and it's already your third appearance up on this stage. That's pretty incredible. But the thing that I think amazes me most about this year is that double duty day back in Memorial Day weekend when he drove 1,100 miles. Now, that would be enough to just put me under, but he comes in fourth in both the Daytona 500 and fourth in the Coca-Cola 600. It was an incredible thing to watch. It truly was. The balance of the year, you kept your foot down on that pedal and you showed the guts and the heart of a true competitor. And that's what brought you here. A number two finish with a trophy to recognize that and a check from Winston and NASCAR in the amount of $1,444,920. Congratulations, Tony.
Thank you. I think that's more money I've ever seen at one time in my life. I don't know how Joe's gonna get out of here with it. Tell you what, we left Daytona, 36th in points this year and ended up second. We're really, really excited about our season. We all endured many ups and downs this season and I experienced plenty of my own. But it strengthened my feelings that I'm surrounded by some of the best people in all of auto racing. We were able to raise $240,000 for Kyle Petteri's Victory Junction Gang Camp with the help of Home Depot, Joe Gibbs Racing, Target Chip Ganassi Racing for our double duty effort. We also donated over 20,000 toys for the U.S. Marine Corps' Toys for Tots Drive with the help of Home Depot, Coca-Cola, Action Performance, Joe Gibbs Racing, and Interstate Batteries. You know, there's a lot of people that we got to thank, and I always want to start off with the NASCAR officials because you're the hardest working group of people in all of the motorsports. And second, the NASCAR fans. You guys are the most dedicated of all in motorsports. And my fellow NASCAR drivers, you guys are the best drivers and the best group of people that you could deal with in motorsports. Jeff, I want to congratulate you and Rick and Robbie on a great year this year. One day I want to sit at the head table too, so save me a spot here in the future, I hope. Kevin Harvick, congratulations on winning not only the Busch Series Championship, but the Rookie of the Year title also. I know how much it means to win that Rookie Championship. I also have a lot of special thanks for a lot of people that have, that make this possible every week. And first of all, I want to thank Greg Zivadelli. He's three people in one. He's a great mechanic, a great coach, and as of September 5th, a great dad. So congratulations to you and Nan for the birth of your son, Zach. Second of all, my crew for standing behind me through the entire season with hard work and never-ending support. And also thanks to your families for providing the same kind of support to you. Bobby Labonte, the best teammate a driver could ever ask for on and off the track. Jimmy Makar for your knowledge and leadership. Mark Cronquist for giving up so much of your life just so that we can go fast. And Al Shuford for getting my body ready to race at Indy and Charlotte in the same day. And last but not least, Joe Gibbs for sticking up for me and giving me a chance to live my dream at competing at Indy. There's a lot of people that work in our office, not only at Joe Gibbs Racing, but at True Speed Enterprises, that all your hard work means so much, and you never see the end result on the racetrack, but we couldn't go to the racetrack without you guys. And the hardworking folks that travel with me and keep me in line, Kirsten Kinder, Mike Arning, Eddie Jarvis, and Bob Burris, thanks for everything you guys do to get me out of bed in the morning and be where I'm supposed to be somewhat on time. I want to thank everyone else associated with Joe Gibbs Racing. It's a total team effort, and I appreciate their support of all of our racing program. and all of my associate and personal sponsors, along with my family and friends who have supported me throughout my racing career. First of all, Home Depot, the best sponsor I've ever had, and with equally great people, 250,000 exactly, who have the same passion for winning as I do. And our CEO, Bob Nardelli, is with us this evening, and just like he's been with us all year. But this is his first NASCAR season, and tonight, Bob, you finally get to take that rookie stripe off. But we appreciate your support for it and everything you've done for us this season. We also have to thank Rigid Power Tools, Husky Tools and Boxes, Pontiac, Goodyear Tires, Coca-Cola, MB&A, Nike, Action Performance, Gum Out, Daewoo, Chef Boyardee for keeping me fed, Old Spice, Cheez-Its, Augie, Wix Filters, EDS, and my personal sponsors, MCI WorldCom, Bass Pro Shops, Sea-Doo, and Simpson Race Products. There's a lot of other important people, too, that make this all happen. And first of all, we got to thank NASCAR, and I got to take this jacket off. I'm getting warm up here. It's hot up here today. You wouldn't think we'd have that in New York this time of year, but... Sorry about that. I've been wearing this ever since Talladega, and I'm so comfortable, I hate to take it off sometimes. But I do want to thank NASCAR for all they're doing in the quest for safety and making us safer. And I think I can speak for all the drivers since I was the last one to finally wear a head neck restraint that we appreciate all you guys are doing. And even though I put up that resistance, I know you guys are looking out for our best interest. So I'll wear this day in and day out. So as long as it takes. I also want to thank a guy that's very important to me, especially when I'm in trouble with NASCAR. He's the first guy that's on the phone making sure that I'm not in any legal trouble. That's Kerry Agajanian, our attorney. My mother and father for their continued support, and obviously Krista for putting up with all the good days and the bad days. And I promise you, I give you more bad days than good days, so I appreciate how much you put up with me. And I also want to thank Teresa Earnhardt, and thank you for all your strength. It's allowed all of us to carry on with such a sad time while never forgetting the impact your husband has left on all of us. So I look forward to a happy holiday season and spend it with my family and encourage you to do the same. And we look forward to seeing everybody in Daytona in February. Thanks again.
We'll start the awards for our championship team in a few minutes, but for most of tonight, we've been recognizing drivers for their on-track achievements. We don't want to lose sight, though, of the countless off-track contributions made by every NASCAR Winston Cup Series driver. Each year, the True Value Man of the Year Award recognizes these humanitarian off-track activities. The Man of the Year, announced in a moment, will receive a cash prize of $100,000, which will be split evenly between the driver and the charity of his choice. This year's winners were nominated quarterly. The nominees are Mark Martin, Rick Mast, Jeff Gordon, and Bill Elliott. And to announce the True Value Man of the Year, welcome Mr. Fred Kirst, representing True Value. Fred?
Thanks, Alan. As the official hardware store of NASCAR, we have a theme at True Value, which is help is just around the corner. We believe the NASCAR True Value Man of the Year Award captures the spirit and commitment of our 5,800 independently owned and operated retailers around the world. True Value would like to congratulate all of the quarterly winners. After thorough consideration, True Value and NASCAR are pleased to announce that Jeff Gordon has been named the 2001 NASCAR True Value Man of the Year. Jeff, congratulations.
I'm a shocker there. I just want to thank True Value. Brooke and I, we had an opportunity to start the Jeff Gordon Foundation a couple years ago, and we've been able to do some tremendous work through our foundation, raise a lot of money for children and families that are in need, that are struggling with some type of illness, like maybe leukemia or some type of cancer.
And we've been so blessed in our lives to have the opportunities that we have to be able to give back. And this means an awful lot to be able to not only give the $50,000, but the additional $50,000, because I'm not going to accept any of it, that we're going to give back to the Jeff Gordon Foundation and continue to give more and more to these great organizations that we support. Thank you.
All right, Jeff. Don't get too comfortable in that seat, because in just a few moments, we'll be honoring our championship team. When we begin the presentations to the champion sponsor and car owner, that's all coming up in just a minute.
And all the drama is on TNT. Saturday night at 8, watch Judy Garland in the timeless classic that proves there's no place like home. Don't miss The Wizard of Oz. And Sunday night at 8, bring the family together for this season's holiday event. See Whoopi Goldberg in the world premiere of Call Me Claus. Saturday night, watch The Wizard of Oz. And Sunday night, see Call Me Claus. Every weekend, all the drama, all weekend long is on TNT.
No matter who you are or what you're into, isn't it nice to know you'll be accepted?
That's why the Redskins' biggest fans, the Hoggets, make sure to bring their Visa cards to the Forecast Boutique. Visa, the official card of the NFL.
Do I look fat in this dress?
Yes!
This is Santa's Workshop 2001. Billions of wish lists come in from around the world, and UPS helps us navigate supply chain management issues.
Oh, coal comes in from the Balkans for the naughty.
Boy band figurines come in from Japan for the nice.
Think about the logistics on that one.
We have been a successful brand for centuries now, and for a number of years, UPS has been an invaluable partner. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus, and he's working with UPS.
Horsepower Chevy Monte Carlo SS.
Green.
The side you show the world is up to you.
The game gets passed down. My father, me, and so on.
I see, that's a strike.
That's called painting the corners.
Which guys do you like?
The guys with the blue hats.
I like the guys with the blue hats, too.
Hey, you want to go to the game and see the guys in the blue hats?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's buy some tickets.
Everything we do is about connecting you to the stuff you love most. Comcast.
What can you do at VHIX.com in 30 seconds or less?
Didn't even break a sweat. VHIX.com, roadmap to the automotive world.
The 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Awards Ceremony is brought to you by Visa. It's everywhere NASCAR fans want to be. By UPS, the official delivery company of NASCAR. And by Team Monte Carlo, the cars more champions depend on. Chevy will be there.
Here's to the nights we felt alive. Here's to the tears you
at Christmas time where the weather has been spectacular. Most of the people that have come for the awards banquet have spent plenty of time on the streets celebrating the spirit of this city. Now here again is Alan Bestwick.
Well, they've been patiently waiting all night while all of the other top 10 finishers and the special awards have been passed out. Now it's time to begin to honor our NASCAR Winston Cup Series championship team. Let's begin with the award to the championship car owner to make that presentation. Please welcome the president of NASCAR, Mr. Mike Helton.
Thank you, Alan. Throughout our history, there have been those whose efforts have raised the standards both on the racetrack and off. His effort began in 1984. His first NASCAR Winston Cup win came at Martinsville Speedway in 1984 with Jeffrey Bodine at the wheel. Since then, his teams have become an organization that has amassed 100 poles and 103 wins in NASCAR. He and Jack Sprague celebrated their third NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series championship earlier this year in Miami, but he and his wife Linda are no strangers to the stage here in New York. They fielded championship teams in 1995, 1997, and 1998 for Jeff Gordon, and in 1996 for Terry Labonte. Back in championship form after defeating leukemia, it's a great honor on behalf of Bill France and all of NASCAR to welcome to the stage the 2001 champion car owner, Rick Hendrick.
Thank you, Mike, and good evening. It's an honor to be here tonight with these great champions. Some of the 24 team guys are up there in the balcony. You guys are making a lot of noise. You having some fun? To our hosts, Winston and Andy Schindler, thanks for a great week and many years supporting NASCAR. I was so moved during Ground Zero on Tuesday and watching those tributes to New York and Dale. They truly hit home about the tears shed by our nation and our sport, but they also speak of courage and the spirit to overcome, rebuild, and go on. Both events have heroes. Bill and Betty Jane France have been wonderful examples of courage in the racing world. Mr. France was a tremendous inspiration to me when I was ill. Thank God he's with us here tonight. And he'd be the first to recognize his support and tremendous support, beginning with Lisa France, Brian, Jim France, and Mike Helton. Others are not with us, but their memories remain. We honor those we lost and promise we will never forget how much they meant to all of us. Jeff, thank you, buddy. You know, not only for the four championships, but everything you've done for Hendrick Motorsports and for the way you and Brooke have touched our lives. Your driving talent, it speaks for itself, but often one that people realize the enormous amount of time and energy you spend helping others. You never seek recognition. You are true champions in many, many ways. And I'd like to recognize someone else pretty special, my wife, Linda. I want to thank you for the 30 years that you've sacrificed and let me race. Thank you for our wonderful children, Ricky, who won his first race this year, and Lynn, our daughter, who's here tonight with her new husband, Marshall. My mom and dad couldn't be here tonight, but I'm so grateful they're with us watching from home. I love all of you very much. I'd also like to thank all the team's family members who gave so much this year. And this team is special. You are true warriors. 2 years ago, they lost a crew chief, the pit crew, the engine assembler, and the lead fabricator. Jeff, you and Brian Weitzel, who deserves to be up here tonight, stepped up, recruited Robbie, and began to rebuild. Tonight, we're celebrating one of the most profound comebacks in the sport. I can't say enough about Robbie as a person, a crew chief, and a leader. This team is very special because there are no egos, and they have so much fun together. The credit for that goes to Robbie and Brian's leadership. Randy Dorton and Rick Wetzel, you're responsible for those engines, and we never missed a beat. There's so many other people we need to thank. Ken Howes, Eddie Dickerson, Rex Stump, Jim Wall, and a special thanks to my brother, John. To over 350 employees at Hendrick Motorsports, you all share in this great honor. We have the greatest sponsors in racing. DuPont, you began with us in the early 90s, and now the name DuPont has become synonymous with NASCAR Chad Holliday, thank you for believing in us. Lou Savelli, Ed Donnelly, and Joe Jackson, thank you for this year for one of the era of a 5-year partnership deal. Pepsi and Frito-Lay, you've helped us make Jeff a household name with your promotional commitment. GMAC, Delphi, Quaker State, Haas Automation, Goodyear, Mack Trucks, EDS, Mack Tools, Kellogg's, UAW, and Net Zero, thank you. And Lowe's will be joining us next year. To all our friends at Chevrolet, couldn't do it without you. You folks, congratulations on your championship. Congratulations, John Middlebrook, sorry about that, on your manufacturer's title this year. And we're happy we could give you another truck championship and cup championship this year. This trip to New York has given me a chance to reflect on how blessed we are and how recent events have opened our eyes. Even this team and NASCAR's challenges demonstrate the fighting spirit. All of these things tell us we can win if we have faith in God, believe in yourself, and maintain the American spirit. We can prosper no matter what life throws at us. We have a great sport, and we have a great country, and above all, we have great people, especially our fans. I'm proud to be a part of it all. God bless you, and God bless America, and I hope you and your families have a wonderful holiday season. Thank you.
Our next award presenter snuck out ahead of his cue. I was going to tell you this wonderful story about how he knows something about winning these championships. See this trophy over here that lists all the NASCAR Winston Cup Series champions? Fifth one from the left bottom row is my broadcast buddy here from NBC and TNT. Please welcome the 1973 Winston Cup champion, Mr. Benny Parsons.
Thank you, Alan. Thank you, Alan. You know, Robbie Loomis is used to being surrounded by greatness. After working under 7-time NASCAR Winston Cup champion Richard Petty as the crew chief for Petty Enterprises, Loomis joined Hendrick Motorsports to serve as crew chief for 3-time champion Jeff Gordon in 1999. But until now, Robbie never experienced what it was like to be a champion in NASCAR's Premier Series. Now, Robbie, you know what it feels like. While getting Gordon out of the pits first all season, Robbie Loomis led the 2014 to 6 victories and made all the right decisions down the stretch. On behalf of NASCAR, please welcome the championship crew chief of the number 24 DuPont team, Robbie Loomis.
Thank you, Benny. Woo! It's great to be in New York City. I humbly stand before you tonight, not the works of my own, but with the help of many whom I'd like to thank. I have to keep it short, however, because Mr. Hendrick said we must get ready for Daytona. First of all, I need to thank God for giving me all the opportunities and making me stronger through failures along the way. Mr. France and the France family and everyone at NASCAR for building such a great sport. The sponsors, DuPont, Goodyear, Chevrolet, and RJR. The Petty family has taught me so much about racing and even more about life. Richard, you are the king. Kyle and Patty, your strength and courage in the face of tragedy inspire me. You're a role models for us all. Dale Inman, you believed in me. And I know, Dale, I got 7 more to go to catch you. To my family, thanks for providing your love and support. Your forgiveness for missed birthday cards and phone calls is part of your unconditional love. I'm delighted to have my family with me tonight. Thanks, Mom and Dad. I love you. To all the NASCAR fans, seeing the excitement in your eyes makes it exciting for us. The valuable lessons I've learned from each driver I've worked have made this a reality. The world's greatest drivers are in this room tonight. They motivate us each week. In the words of Vince Lombardi, this award is a result of a combined effort of you. Do it, guys. Papa Joe, you built the foundation for these championships. Rick and Linda Hendrick, congratulations. The tools and talented people you surround us with make it possible to achieve our dreams. 8 championships in 7 years speaks louder than words. John and Kathy, thanks for your friendship, kindness, and spiritual touch. Randy Dorton and Rick Wetzel, best engine program in Winston Cup. Hendrick Engineering Group, Rex, Gary, and Jim, thanks most of all for not always agreeing with me. Ken House, thanks for your knowledge and wisdom. You're a true racer. Eddie Dickerson and everyone in the chassis shop, great cars, and I know, guys, great bodies. To all Hendrick Motorsports employees, I appreciate your hard work, and I hope you're having fun at the party back in Charlotte. Now the ones who pour their sweat and tears into the 24 DuPont race team. Your talent, hard work, leadership, and dedication are unprecedented. Together, we have accomplished great things. Brian Weitzel, four-time champion. Without you, none of this would have been possible tonight. Oh, and Mary, you're a great cook. Well, I guess we let the cat out of the bag. Now everyone knows what I've long known. Jeff Gordon, you're one of the all-time greats. Jeff, you believed in us when at times it was hard to believe in ourselves. Your focus, determination, and unassuming nature helped to unite our team. Everyone knows that every champion has to play from the heart and have a strong heart. Those of you who know her know there's no stronger heart than that of Brooke Gordon. Brooke, your kindness, compassion, and understanding provides a template for a strong partnership between a husband and a wife and business partners alike. In closing, I'm going to leave you with this vision that led me here. Lord, let us not get caught up in our circumstances at hand. However, let us look forward to the opportunities that lie ahead. Thank you, God bless you, and happy holidays. Thank you, guys.
Good work, guys. A few years ago down in Charlotte, Joe Jackson, a district supervisor with DuPont Automotive Coatings, was looking to increase his business. So he started asking around what he could do to get Rick Hendrick's car dealership's body shop business. He was told to get that business, you got to give Hendrick paint for his race cars. Well, naturally, it wasn't long before Rick was talking to the fellows in Wilmington, Delaware. The result, one of the best-known sponsors in motorsports today. To accept the sponsor's trophy for the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship, the president of DuPont Performance Coatings, Mr. Ed Donnelly.
Thank you very much, Benny, and thank you, Joe Jackson, for getting that business for us. I'm very happy tonight to accept the 2001 Championship Sponsor Trophy on behalf of DuPont and our 85,000 employees around the world. This is the fourth time in 9 years that we have won this award. And we like to think that the winning ways and staying power of the DuPont number 24 team have rubbed off on us. Year by year, race by race, they've earned their well-deserved right to all the superlatives they enjoy, including the most important one, champion. We are very proud to be associated with this team. And like any team, they rely on all their players to succeed. The perseverance of Rick Hendrick, the strategy and savvy of crew chief Robbie Loomis, and the skill and competitiveness of the NASCAR marvel Jeff Gordon. And there's also the determination and the lightning speed of the guys in the balcony, the Miracle Men pit crew. And of course, let's not forget the role of the DuPont number 24 car paint scheme, which helped focus the team's all fired up attitude. Not only was it the fastest car on the track many weekends, it was always the best looking. Next year, DuPont will celebrate our 200th year of business. We were founded back when the fastest anyone could go around a track was seated on a race horse. So we've come a long way, and we've been part of the automotive industry from the very beginning. DuPont products not only make race cars faster, they also make the cars on our highways more attractive, more efficient, and they're safer for our families. The DuPont Oval and the number 24 car is a testament to our own staying power, our own vision, determination, our skill, and competitiveness. Maybe that's why we feel so at home with NASCAR champions in the 21st century. And to help celebrate our 200th anniversary next year, the flames of the number 24 car will, on a select few occasions, be replaced by a special anniversary paint scheme that symbolizes DuPont's history of discovering and delivering solutions that make a difference in people's lives. We call these victories the miracles of science. The first anniversary paint scheme will be run on next year's Daytona 500, where our CEO, Chad Holliday, will preside as the Grand Marshal. We're all real happy and proud of that. So for all of us at DuPont, it's been an astonishing ride to the top of the world's most competitive form of auto racing. We thank the DuPont number 24 team, our many thousands of customers, our employees, and the millions of fans who cheer Jeff to victory each weekend. We hope there will be many more next season and the years ahead, and we thank you once again and enjoy the rest of the night. Thank you.
In a moment, we'll begin presenting awards to the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion.
Miss the spectacular memorabilia auction at the I-24 Expo Saturday, December 8th at 9 a.m. Viewing starts at 7 a.m. one day only. All memorabilia is authentic. Cars, guitars, pianos, clothes, posters, jewelry, furniture, nudie suits, antique jukeboxes, and much more. Thousands of items.
Hello, friends. I'm Jim Ed Brown. Make your plans to come down. Be here.
One day only at 9 a.m. December 8th, I-24 Expo Center at I-24 East and Sam Ridley Parkway, exit 66A, just 6 miles from Nashville city limits. Be there.
To celebrate the video DVD release of Dr. Seuss' How the Grinch Stole Christmas starring Jim Carrey, Blockbuster Video and Wendy's will give one lucky person a trip for four to Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida. Visit any participating Blockbuster or Wendy's and pick up your coloring sheet entry form while supplies last. Return your entry by December 9th and you can be selected as the grand prize winner or win a copy of How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Don't be a Grinch. Hurry to Blockbuster Video or Wendy's today.
For you and the team, okay? For later.
And welcome back to New York. In just a few moments, Jeff Gordon will be honored as a four-time NASCAR Winston Cup champion at the ripe old age of 30. In his years as a competitor in this sport, he has shown he can race with grace, win with class, and lead by example. But Jeff is the first guy to tell you this is not a one-man team. He's surrounded by skillful people, the dedicated people of the DuPont team, a team that has painted the portrait of a true champion.
With hard-driving consistency, our 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion led lap after lap, claiming his fourth series title in 7 years, joining Richard Petty and Dale Earnhardt as the only drivers in Winston Cup Series history to capture more than three championships. Gordon's quest for four began with the first of a series leading seven Bud Bowls at Rockingham. In March, Gordon and crew chief Robbie Lewis celebrated the first of six trips to victory lane by cashing in on a Winston No Bull $5 million bonus at Las Vegas. A hard-fought fourth at Bristol and a fifth at Texas set the stage for a remarkable streak of six top three finishes in seven starts, including consecutive runner-up finishes at California and Richmond. A complete team effort and a victory at the Winston led to successive wins at Dover Downs and Michigan in June, the latter of which represented NASCAR win number 100 for Hendrick Motorsports. Yet another Bud Pole effort at Sears Point and the resulting third place finish only reinforced Gordon's versatility behind the wheel. With Wife Brooke looking on, the 1993 Raybestos Rookie of the Year sped to yet another Bud Pole at New Hampshire, yielding a second place finish. Convincing wins at Indianapolis and Watkins Glen in August set the DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet team apart as the ones to beat for the 2001 championship. A runner-up finish at Darlington in September added to Gordon's series leading total of 18 top five finishes. And with a victory at the Kansas inaugural, Gordon extended his point advantage entering the season's final stretch. Top 10 finishes at Martinsville, Talladega, Phoenix, and a title-clinching sixth-place drive at Atlanta sealed the deal for Gordon, Hendrick, Loomis, and the entire DuPont Automotive Finishes team. Jeff Gordon is now the youngest four-time Winston Cup Series champion in NASCAR history. Driving to a season-leading six wins, 18 top fives, and 24 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Rick Hendrick-owned DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet from Pittsboro, Indiana, the four-time and 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, Jeff Gordon.
Okay, you've done this before, you know how this works. Find you a good, comfortable place to stand. You're gonna be here for a while. We've got some things to give you. Let's start with championship awards on behalf of the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company. To make those presentations, please welcome the chairman, CEO, and president of Goodyear Tire and Rubber, Mr. Sam Jabara.
Well, thank you, Alan, and good evening, everyone. It is a privilege to be here tonight to represent Goodyear's 100,000 associates worldwide and to celebrate our 45-year association with NASCAR as we honor Jeff Gordon and his winning team. Drivers like Jeff Gordon display their own spirit and strength of character that is so typical of America. And never was that spirit stronger than it is now, in this great country, in this resilient city, and in the face of current adversity. That spirit lives within Goodyear as well, where for more than a century, we've been a proud American-owned company and a global tire industry leader. Jeff, when you received your third handcrafted 24-karat gold engraved race car replica complete with Goodyear Eagles, I described you as a fleet owner. Now, with this fourth car, I declare you the man with the Midas touch. We salute you, Brooke, and the entire Hendrick Motorsports organization on a phenomenal season, and we are truly proud to be associated with you. Jeff, congratulations.
I haven't learned, have I?
You've done this before. Step back. You've done this before. You know that you've got to wait till you've got all the hardware. Okay. He doesn't learn. The next presentation is the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Championship Diamond Ring and Diamond Pendant. To make that presentation, welcome the First Lady of NASCAR, Betty Jane France, and welcome back, Mr. Mike Helton.
Brooks, you have exemplified a great honor of support for Jeff's racing career, and we hope that you will wear this lovely diamond necklace in good health and continued success. Congratulations. Jeff, this championship ring is your fourth. It is not four times bigger. It is not four times brighter. It is, however, a symbol of the fourth time you have earned the right to stand on this stage as NASCAR Winston Cup champion, something accomplished only twice before. So, as I see it, that entitles the two of you and the entire DuPont team to be four times as proud as you were when you won your first championship. Congratulations.
We've still got more to give to our champion. Those presentations continue in just a moment.
One weekend, one network, three mind-bending trips into The Matrix. Beginning next Friday night, see the network television premiere of The Matrix. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night starting at 8, exclusively on TNT.
He's a pretender determined to find his past. Now, the only thing more shocking than the questions are the answers. The Pretender, Island of the Haunted. See the world premiere Monday, December 10th at 8 on TNT. We know drama.
Store up on great holiday gifts at Pep Boys. Get custom alloy wheels from only $49 each and add a set of 40,000-mile truck tires from just $49.99 each. Get your holiday gifts now at Pep Boys. Store up on great holiday gifts at Pep Boys. Buy a Delta aluminum toolbox, a Weston grill guard or step bar, or some cool performance accessories like these slick APC taillights. Get your holiday gifts now at Pep Boys.
Spent a wonderful evening so far honoring our championship team and driver, and now for the final presentations to Jeff Gordon. It's my pleasure to introduce the chairman and chief executive officer of the R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Mr. Andy Schindler.
Thank you, and good evening. We're here tonight to celebrate another dramatic season of NASCAR Winston Cup racing, and to recognize the extraordinary 2001 series champion, Jeff Gordon. All of us involved with the NASCAR Winston Cup Series have watched it become the greatest motorsports series in the world. At the heart of NASCAR is Bill France and his family. Without their vision, commitment, leadership, NASCAR racing would not be what it is today. I'd like to recognize the France family, as well as NASCAR President Mike Helton and all the men and women of the NASCAR team with a well-deserved round of applause. I also want to extend a special tribute to the millions of dedicated fans, the teams, officials, and sponsors who make the NASCAR Winston Cup Series a spectacular showcase of talent and teamwork. Let's give them all a hand. Talent and teamwork, that's what NASCAR Winston Cup racing is all about. That, along with an unflinching dedication to being the best, is why the number 24 Hendrick Motorsports DuPont Chevrolet team came out on top. This year's championship truly is a triumph of talent, teamwork, and dedication. A year and a half ago, the pundits suggested it would take years for Jeff Gordon and the 24 team to rebuild and get back into championship form. But the triumph of teamwork has proven them wrong. This is Rick Hendrick's fifth Winston Cup championship. Tonight he joins only three other owners who have won five or more NASCAR Winston Cup championships: Petty Enterprises, Junior Johnson Racing, and Richard Childress Racing. Rick, it's great to be here with you tonight to celebrate your team's fantastic achievement. Rick is a quiet, intense, and highly focused leader who is driven by an unrelenting commitment to teamwork. He firmly believes that races and championships are won as a result of molding natural talent into an effective team. Rick prominently displays a sign at Hendrick Motorsports that serves as the motto for the 24 team. It says, and I quote, Teamwork is the fuel that allows common people to produce uncommon results. The simple but powerful philosophy is what has driven the 24 team and Hendrick Motorsports to its extraordinary level of success. Rick, congratulations, buddy. The number 24 DuPont Chevrolet team is a true testament to what a talented team of professionals can accomplish when they dedicate themselves to excellence in everything that they do. Let's hear it for the 24 DuPont Chevrolet team. Way to go, guys. The team's engine builder is Rick Wetzel. His friends call him Champ. Rick has built winning engines for the Indianapolis 500, the Brickyard 400, the Daytona 500, and now his first Winston Cup championship. Rick, you have truly earned the nickname Champ. Congratulations. This is also the first Winston Cup championship for crew chief Robbie Loomis. Robbie grew up in NASCAR. He started out as a general mechanic at age 24 in Richard Petty's shop, and his dedication and talent have propelled him to the top. Robbie was Richard Petty's crew chief in Atlanta 9 years ago this month when the King drove his last race and Jeff Gordon drove his first. Robbie is a modest and quiet leader and strategist. In only his second year as crew chief for the 24 team, he's won a championship. Let's hear it for Robbie Loomis. Now let's turn to the man of the hour, Jeff Gordon. Only two other drivers have ever won four or more Winston Cup championships. Two giants of this sport, the great Richard Petty and the great Dale Earnhardt. Tonight, Jeff Gordon joins that very elite group. Everyone who's watched Jeff for the past 9 years knows he's a natural. And when you combine that kind of talent with the dedication and teamwork of the 24 team, you wind up where we are tonight. Jeff is the consummate professional on and off the track. He understands the sport inside and out. He's a gentleman and a giant in NASCAR Winston Cup racing. Jeff is calm, focused, intense, and competitive, and he's totally dedicated to getting results. This year, Jeff took the checkered flag in a 6 NASCAR Winston Cup point races, including 24 top 10 finishes and 18 top fives. He won the Winston for the third time, and in a backup car, no less. And he won this year's Winston No Bull 5 in Las Vegas, his fourth No Bull 5 win. Jeff now has 58 career wins, placing him 7th in all-time victories. Jeff, I believe the check I'm about to give you will place you first in all-time winnings. It is my pleasure and honor to present you with $3,787,681 as this year's NASCAR Winston Cup champion. We're about to run out of money, but there's actually more. He has an extra bonus of $1 million for your Winston No Bull 5 win in Vegas, bringing the total to $4,787,681. Ladies and gentlemen, four-time NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon.
Thank you very much. No need to stand for me. Thank you so much, Andy. I got a little bit worried, I got to admit, when we first got here. I was afraid they might forget the check, too. So glad that he definitely had that on him. And that's an unbelievable amount of money. I just can't even fathom this. Let me take a chance real quick to thank Goodyear, Sam, and all their folks for doing so much for each and every one of us as competitors out there. We feel so safe to be on the best tires that there are in the world. And we're just, we got a chance actually a year ago to go there and see their facility. And it's amazing what they put into each and every tire that's built. We all, and I think I speak on behalf of everybody, we all thank you so much for what you do for us. Andy, what can I say? I just want to say thanks to everyone with RJ Reynolds. You guys truly know how to make a champion feel extremely special. And of course, thanks to NASCAR, no doubt about it, this has been the best week of our lives. Bill and Betty Jane, thank you so much. You guys and all your folks from NASCAR do so much for each and every one of us. We're just so proud. And I'm so proud and so excited to be here with all of you, to be with Brooke, the entire 24 team, everyone at Hendrick Motorsports, our sponsors, and all the NASCAR fans watching. As the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, it's so awesome to be back. For our team, this championship meant so much this year. A year where the 24 car got its fourth title, NASCAR saw newer and bigger audiences, Rick Hendrick got his 100th win, and Robbie Loomis won his first championship. It was a pretty amazing year and really proved what a strong team we have. But while it was a great year for us and our team, it was a very tough year for our sport and our country. For NASCAR, the year started with the huge loss of Dale. And that loss has been there all year long and will always be there. We'll never forget what he brought to the NASCAR and how he helped the sport reach new heights. He was a friend to so many, and man, what a competitor. For me personally, I learned an awful lot from him on and off the track, and I'll never forget it. Of course, everyone was affected by September 11th. And being here in New York, it's especially difficult. Had a chance to go to Ground Zero earlier this week. I can't even put into words the scene there. The devastation is absolutely overwhelming. We'll never forget those who were lost that day and their bravery, the New York police and fire departments. And we saw them earlier, but we're so proud to have some of them here with us tonight. Thanks, guys, for being here, and thanks for what you do for us. As I stand here tonight, I want you to know this championship is very special. They all mean a lot, and they're all different. But this one feels more like 95 when we won our first, because in both cases, nobody really expected us to win. We finished last season in ninth with 3 wins. We had new people, a new pit crew, and we're still getting used to working together. And although you always go into each new season hoping to make a run at the championship, this year, well, we were realistic. We wanted to step things up from last year, so we set a goal to win races and finish in the top 5 in points. We knew it'd be better than last year, but we didn't think we'd be as strong as we were. So for us to finish the season with 6 wins, 18 top 5s, 6 poles, and win the championship, we even surprised ourselves. Looking back over the year, I guess what means the most to me is how we work together as a team to overcome adversity. We've had a lot of challenges over the past few years, several members of our team moving on, success on the track not coming the way it had before, and the belief some people had that our team wouldn't be a threat for the championship. So we came together, we worked together to prove that we had the drive, the desire, the resources, and the components to be back on top. We rebuilt our team, putting new people in place, and convincing Robbie Loomis to join us. And I gotta give a lot of credit to this crew. This season, they came together. They believed in themselves and grew into the strongest unit I've ever, and I mean this, I've ever been a part of. You guys are so awesome. So awesome, man. I love you guys. Awesome. Truly was a team effort this year. I can't tell you how much that means to me. We've all matured as individuals and as a team. We knew how to step it up, and we did. And because of that, we developed a stronger bond between us, which helped us realize what might be possible. Las Vegas was our first sign that something pretty special was going on. It's a difficult track. We struggled there last year, and we started deep in the field. We worked our way to the front, and eventually, we won the race. I think that race showed us right then that this could be our year. And of course, we had to back that up with some other solid finishes, but the way we worked together and performed that day was unbelievable. I know it took my confidence to a new level, and I think it did for the team, too. From that point on, we felt that kind of confidence for the rest of the season. Las Vegas showed us what was possible, and our team made the rest of it happen. We have such a great team, a smart team. Of course, that includes the engine department. Randy, Diane, thank you so much for all you do. All your folks there at Hendrick Motorsports in the engine department. Of course, Champ, congratulations on Engine Builder of the Year. Engines were awesome all year. Thanks to all the guys in the chassis and R&D areas. And thanks especially to everyone who makes up the 24 team. And also my teammates from the 25 and 5 teams, you guys play a big role, and we appreciate everything. We capitalized on our opportunities and built on our strengths. And this season, our strength of experience actually worked for us. As I said, we had a lot of new members this year, but as we battled for the championship, the veteran members of the 24 team helped guide our new guys through the highs and lows of the season. Going through 3 other championships meant that we'd been there before. It's a long season, and it's how you get through the peaks and valleys that determines who comes out on top. Our team, and in fact, every team racing today, has a great model for overcoming challenges and building on its strengths. And that's NASCAR itself. A sport has grown so much over the past 53 years, and yet it's always kept its focus where it matters, on its fans. And this was a big year, huge year for NASCAR. With the new television coverage, there was an even greater opportunity for the sport to grow, to stay in touch with our fans, and to expand our audience. NBC, Turner, Fox, FX, great job. I love what I do. I really do. I very much love what I do. But I also have such a passion for this sport, and that definitely goes beyond winning races. I want to see our sport reach its ultimate level, to the level I believe it's capable of, has worked hard for, and deserves. I'll contribute any way I can to ensure that NASCAR's success continues. We took a huge step this year, and I was proud to win the championship in a year where the sport really broke through. With all that said, there are so many people and organizations that made winning this championship possible. I first want to thank DuPont, Ed, Karen, all of those at DuPont. Thank you for everything that you guys do for us. Chad and Holiday, we're so thankful to have you here. We appreciate your support. Thanks to Quaker State, Pepsi, and Fritos. These guys are such an important part of our team, and I'm glad we can celebrate a championship together. Thanks also to GMAC, Chevrolet, as well as Haas, EDS, Delphi, Tropicana, and a new member, Lowe's. I want to mention the people who work so hard behind the scenes. At JG Inc., thank you to Bob Brannon. You do an awful lot for me on many levels. A chance to win my 50th win. But this was a special year, because even a really special year for Rick also, because he celebrated his 100th win at Michigan. In between, we've become partners, friends, and our relationship has really evolved. Which is a good thing, because I signed a lifetime contract and he's stuck with me now. Rick is key to everything that our team has accomplished, and I'm so happy he's here with us tonight, healthy and strong. Glad you're here, buddy. I also want to thank Linda, Rick's wife, and of course also John and Kathy Hendrick for everything that they've done to help make us successful. Robbie Loomis, what can I say? He's just such a good guy. He's likable, and I don't know anybody that doesn't like him. And I understand a little bit more now tonight why Ricky Rudd and his crew chief like you so much. We'll talk about that later, Mike Maswain. But he's sharp, he's knowledgeable, ethical, and available, right? A little inside joke there, sorry, Rock. To me, he's what a champion is absolutely made of. I've really enjoyed our relationship as it's grown. For us to click early, only in our second year, says a lot. This was the first time he battled for a championship, but you would have never known it. His calmness was reflected in the rest of us and helped our team always see the big picture. Congratulations, buddy, or I should say champ, right? I also want to thank Brian Weitzel, our team manager. This guy is very important. His relationship with Robbie and our entire team, not to mention his talents and skills, are key to making it all work. Of course, my life wouldn't be the same without Brooke. We've had an amazing week. Like I mentioned, probably the best week of our lives. Celebrate our anniversary earlier this year, or earlier this week. Her birthday yesterday, and you know what makes it so special is to be able to spend a week like this and a year like this with big check. Someone that you love and means so much to you. Finally, I reached two other milestones this year. Turned 30, and realized that I've been racing for 25 years. Hard to believe, that it's been not that long. But I have my parents certainly to thank for that, for getting me into this and supporting my racing for so many years. Thank you for everything. My faith in God has always been a big part of my life, and I felt His presence this year even more so than in the past. I'm truly blessed in both my life and my career to live and work with the people that I do. Now, I know that Andy already mentioned the sign that we have up in our shop about teamwork being the fuel that allows common people to achieve uncommon results. But really, truly, for me, that says it all about this year and this team. What I've seen this year is the power of what can happen when people believe in themselves and support one another. And I've seen firsthand that when a team sets its mind to a goal and works together, any obstacle can be overcome and any dream can become a reality. Now, the Daytona 500 is just 79 days away. Or I should say 79 days are long, long ways away. But you know what? With this team right here, I wish it was tomorrow, guys. Wish it was tomorrow. Can't wait to get to Daytona. Thank you. Good night. God bless you.
Jeff, settle back into your chair right there. We've got one final thing to show you. That chair that you had to wait for earlier, you can get it now. And take a look at this piece of video presentation. Listen to the words real careful.
He was just a boy when he took to the track. Set his sight on a dream and never looked back. Even then, a champion coming in first place. It almost seems Jeff Gordon was born to race. 20 years later, he's still at the wheel with a heart full of passion and nerves like steel. Set a lot of records all along the way. If a track could talk, you'd hear it say, there goes Jeff in number 24, out in front with the pedal to the floor. Home and that's NASCAR Winston Cup again. Going for the Winston Cup is a long, hard quest. If you win it more than once, you're the best of the best. When you win four times, that's a NASCAR dream. One he's proud to share with the rest of the team. There goes Jeff in number 24. Out in front with the pedal to the floor. Rolling down the straightaway, flying like the wind. Taking home the NASCAR Winston Cup again. Season's over, it's been a great year. Jeff, your fans are still waiting, hoping they're gonna hear. Yeah, there goes Jeff in number 24. Out in front with the pedal to the floor.
Ladies and gentlemen, for a final bow, our champion, Jeff Gordon.
Holiday season, Garth Brooks is giving Christmas a whole new swing.
I have to find somebody to take my place before midnight on Christmas Eve.
I don't suppose you'd take no for an answer, would you?
Call me Santa, call me Kringle, call me El Saint Nick.
Whoopi Goldberg and Nigel Hawthorne in a movie that finds the true spirit of Christmas with new music from Garth Brooks. Call Me Claus. See the world premiere Sunday at 8, only on TNT.
We have pilots down behind enemy lines.
There is a time for diplomacy.
We authorize a search and rescue.
The American people want their pilot back. Now what is the problem?
But now...
You will lose your command.
So be it.
Time is up.
How soon can your team be ready?
Say the word and we'll saddle up.
Behind enemy lines.
Let's go get our boy back.
Rated PG-13. Now playing only in theaters.
Don't miss the spectacular memorabilia auction at the I-24 Expo Saturday, December 8th at 9 a.m. Viewing starts at 7 a.m. one day only. All memorabilia is authentic. Cars, guitars, pianos, clothes, posters, jewelry, furniture, nudie suits, antique jukeboxes, and much more. Thousands of items.
Hello, friends. I'm Jim Ed Brown. Make your plans to come down. Be here.
One day only at 9 a.m. December 8th, I-24 Expo Center at I-24 East and Sam Ridley Parkway, exit 66A, just 6 miles from Nashville city limits. Be there. Hey, listen up. Let's get ready to join Gold's Gym. 3 24-hour Nashville locations that will reshape your future. Mention this commercial and pay only $19.99 a month for a limited time only. 24-hour Gold's Gym offers the best training and fitness programs available for all ages. Call now and get started today for only $19.99 a month. Get out of the cold and heat up with 24-hour Gold's Gym. Gold's Gym, Antioch, Rivergate, and Brentwood.
The 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series Awards Ceremony is brought to you by Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade, is it in you? And by Pep Boys. All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys. And by Behind Enemy Lines. It's time to cross the line.
And welcome back to the Waldorf. Bill Weber along with Benny Parsons up here in the balcony. And just an amazing season, BP, and an amazing night.
It really was. I mean, Garth Brooks out there. But you know, Jeff Gordon is unbelievable, Bill. In his speech, with $3.7 million in his hands, he's getting his crew pumped up for next year. Did you hear that?
Yeah, check was $4.7 with that million-dollar bonus from Vegas.
And he's getting the guys ready for next year to come back for number five.
Yeah, because what's the first question he's going to get at the party tonight?
Can you repeat next year like you did back in 1998?
We'll see what happens. Benny, enjoyed it. I'm glad we got to spend another season together, and I look forward to 2002.
Me too, Bill.
Well, this is always a night of tribute, but this was also an evening of tears. Together, that combination is a perfect reflection of the last 10 months. Nothing, not even time, will erase the memory of our losses. But those memories should not rob us of our passion to compete or the glory of celebrating success. Tonight, one guest of honor and an honors list of guests. We're proud you were part of it. For Alan Bestwick, Benny Parsons, and our entire TNT team, I'm Bill Weber. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you at Daytona.
Here's to the nights we felt alive. Here's to the tears you knew you'd cry. Here's to goodbye, tomorrow's gonna come too soon. All my
has been a presentation of TNT Sports.